Assembly Hall in Champaign, Illinois. We welcome you to the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John. One game in the record books already, and the ACC has jumped out ahead. North Carolina State beating back Michigan. And here tonight, we open with Maryland and Illinois. Welcome, everybody, with the coach, Steve Lab, and I'm Brett Musburger. First of all, the news. Akinne Ebekwe, the big man from Maryland, will not play tonight, out with an ankle injury that knocks out a dozen points and seven rebounds a game. What will Maryland do here against the Illini?
Well, Gary Williams also misses the experience of Ebekwe, a senior, tough place to play, Assembly Hall, but Gary Williams still has at his disposal a very talented team. DJ Strawberry, Mike Jones will be relied on heavily, and opportunities for young freshmen like Eric Hayes and Gravis Vasquez.
As for the Fighting Illini, they are searching for an identity. Yes, they're 7-0, but they are looking for a quality win.
John's Superman Pan Pizza, piled high with the works. Seven tasty toppings. Call now or order online and get a large Superman Pan Pizza for $12.99. $12.99, including a $3 coupon for Superman Returns on DVD.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
We're not even in the right seats.
Order the red taco.
And your old lady's hot.
Oh, eat it up, buddy.
Is that part of the show?
Call Progressive Direct today. Operators are not standing by.
Yes, we are. We're here 24/7 to handle any car insurance need.
But you're not an operator.
Well, technically, no.
You're an intensely trained licensed professional.
Yeah, well.
And everyone here has a chair. Look, they're seated comfortably, ready to help people save on car insurance. So like I said, call Progressive Direct today. Think easier, think Progressive.
This is an actual reenactment.
Mary had just picked up her kids and was heading home to make dinner. Just then, in the blink of an eye, nothing happened.
Events like this occur countless times every day. Progressive Direct is doing something about it, giving real savings to these good drivers. In fact, good drivers who switched to Progressive saved hundreds right away.
ACC Big Ten Challenge is presented by Papa John's. Order pizza online 24 hours a day at papajohns.com. And in part by Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry, with five times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores. And Toyota, moving forward.
Illinois has now won 51 consecutive non-conference games here in Assembly Hall. The third member of our team, Aaron Andrews, tells us about a young man who, well, he wanted badly to play this one, Aaron.
He certainly did. Illini guard Chester Frazier, Brent, this was the game he had circled on his calendar. Grew up a Maryland fan in his native city of Baltimore. Now, I was told by the Illini staff before this game, it was questionable if he was going to go tonight. In the Illini's last game versus Bradley, he twisted his ankle so bad that the coaches said if it wasn't Maryland, then they would have sat him out tonight. The key for Chester Frazier tonight, Brent, with that said, is to be calm out there. That is something Bruce Weber has been stressing with him all year.
And Aaron, Chester hopes to get help by the return of a young man who's missed a half dozen games. Jamar Smith, he's a scorer. He'll come off the bench. DJ Strawberry, Maryland's leading scorer. Gary Williams telling us at the shoot-around today, he has been our best player so far. Let's check in now on the starting lineups for the Terrapins. And Mike Jones, DJ, is there along with young Eric Hayes, the freshman guard. James Gist and Bambale Osby. And he, of course, was moved to the starting lineup. Frazier, McBride, and Brock, along with big Warren Carter and Sean Pruitt up front for the Illini. A veteran officiating crew, Ted Hillary, Ted Valentine, and Steve Wilmer will toss it up and get us underway here. Controlled by Maryland and their traveling Reds. What should we look for offensively, Coach?
Well, you'll see some flex offense, also some motion with ball screens. Maryland very talented, but there's the quick steal by Frazier.
Frazier! And down goes the basketball. I've been waiting all day to show that.
What a setup. Couldn't have scripted it any better for the Illini. That's what Frazier brings. He's a ball hawker, tremendous pressure and energy, a floor leader.
What a great way to start. Jones maneuvers in close to the hoop. This is going to be high-energy basketball, folks. Winds up in Sean Pruitt's hands, and here come the Illini.
Both teams with excellent quickness. The edge to the Illini with the Beckway out. The size advantage clearly to Bruce Weber's team.
Searching for the quality shot. McBride back. Lances off the glass. Offensive rebound. All ball, no foul. Pruitt had it knocked out of bounds, looking for the foul. Here's the veteran, Gary Williams. He has missed the NCAA tournament the last 2 years. He's not a happy camper. The fans aren't happy. But Gary thinks he can get back big time this year.
That's a good point, Brent. They play with a hard edge. We see an offensive foul here. Player control. Carter lowers the shoulder.
Here is Bruce Weber. Fourth season as the Illini's head coach, looking for his 200th career win here in the ACC Big Ten Challenge versus Maryland.
You have to remember, Brent, this is really the first road game for this Maryland team. They played at home, they played at neutral sites in the Garden, but Assembly Hall, much different than neutral site or playing the comforts of your home court.
Steve, the Illini coaching staff telling us today we've been thriving on defense, and we have seen that demonstrated here tonight. Jump shot not there, yanked away by the young man they call Boom, Bambale Osby. He's got his hands full underneath. Let's see if he can boom this one, and he does. Just kissed it off the glass. Frazier handling the ball under pressure. It was deflected into the backcourt. No violation there. Ted Hillary right on top of it.
Gary Williams enjoying coaching this Maryland team, talking about their selfless attitude, their work ethic, their defensive mindset, the qualities that have been lacking the past two seasons when they did not make the tournament in March.
Maryland not allowing the Illini to penetrate off the dribble. With three on the shot, glancing shot, Brock goes for it. Maryland comes up with the loose ball.
Maryland gives away some size, but still a very dangerous offensive team. You see the curl in the lane by Strawberry. Nice screen, soft touch, good lift on that shot.
Coach, he made good plays at both ends. That was him down here in the corner defensively. Six up on that curl. Good-looking player.
6 foot five, complete player, a senior, a quiet leader.
There's a block in the lane. Back comes Maryland again. That was Gist who rejected that ball. Good athletic ability there. He comes through at the other end, too.
Boy, nice pass, threading the needle. Hayes in transition. Good vision leading the break. The Terrapins so dangerous when they get out in the open court.
Illini have a score since that opening steal by Frazier. Pruitt backs in off iron. Ice cold from the field. Headman, Osby underneath, knocked out of bounds. Maryland basketball.
Here Hayes with excellent court vision. A point guard that looks up the floor. You see the block leading to the open court opportunity for Hayes. Drops the dime for the easy deuce.
And Gist off the inbounds play on the Little jump hook in the lane, making it 8-2. The Terps out ahead, 16-22 to go. The Illini, 1 of 6 from the field here against Maryland. Tough defense, man-to-man.
Aggressive, full-court pressure. Again, playing with that salty, hard edge. The team very determined to get back into the NCAA tournament. One player goes out like a Beckway. It gives an opportunity for other players to step up, get more minutes, a chance to prove their ability.
And knocking it down is Alvin Brock. 6'5" with a Beckway watching, not going to play if you just joined us because of an injured ankle. 6'9" power man for Maryland on the sideline here tonight. Jones getting to the baseline, having it their way right now, Steve. This Maryland team is very, very good without a Beckley.
Well, they share the basketball. They have multiple players who can pass, catch, create off the bounce. And they have that unselfish attitude.
Brock left open, left baseline, aired one out.
They get down the floor so quickly. They fill lanes. They look ahead for one another.
There's the three. Mike Jones knocks three, and they run out to a 13-4 lead here in Champaign. The look on the Illini faces, they're stunned.
You know, FedEx really helped us with our overnight shipping, even heavy stuff. Now I've added FedEx Ground for everyday shipping.
FedEx is saving us a ton of time. So why aren't we getting more done?
Maybe we should get rid of the half pipe.
No, the half pipe stays.
Gotta keep the half pipe.
FedEx Ground. Fast, reliable, and for less than you think.
Maryland leads at 13-4. The ACC Big Ten Challenge will continue on ESPN and ESPN2. Now at 9 Eastern, right after us, big one at Duke. Indiana and Duke. And then at 9:30 over on ESPN2, Miami, the Hurricanes travel to Evanston to play Northwestern. Both games in high definition. So it's the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's.
More full court pressure by the Terrapins, utilizing that team speed, but a careless turnover by Jamar Smith.
And so Jamar Smith checks in for the first time. His initial contribution, a turnover.
ESPN College Game Day, Saturdays at 10 a.m.
Giving a gift from Jared can cause quite a stir.
Hey, everyone! He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
You went to Jared.
Not every jewelry store gets this reaction, but nothing else is Jared. Jared's selection is truly extensive, built piece by piece to offer distinctiveness, attractive pricing, and style.
I went to Jared.
That's Jared, the one and only Galleria of Jewelry.
He went to Jared.
Strange going on. Over 1,000 people insist they've seen something in Loch Ness. And yet when science is applied, like this expedition here, what's going on?
I don't believe it. I don't believe it.
Do you see that? There. Oh my.
When you've got a burning, scratchy, sore throat, a few blasts can change everything. Introducing Vicks 44 Sore Throat. Fast sore throat pain relief with cooling Vicks vapors. New Vicks 44 Sore Throat. Tell your throat to just chill.
Technology has made your morning easier. Why not your shave? The Philips Norelco Smart Touch XL is designed to shave more, with 3 shaving rings in each shaving head. And it stays on your neck, so even tricky hairs are cut. Simplicity is making every stroke count.
This telecast available on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. Maryland of the ACC has run out to a 13-4 lead on Illinois of the Big Ten. And the last time Illinois lost a non-conference game on this floor, Lon Kruger was their coach. George Washington, the winner, 64-58. 14:50 to go in the first half. Vasquez, another of the talented newcomers for the Terps, checks in on the floor. Getting in underneath, Jones swinging up left hand. Back down by Gist. Here's the three ball. Nailing another one as Jones steps outside.
Nice job by Vasquez to transport the ball to Jones. The hot hand. Traveling call. Unusual amount of turnovers for the Illini on their home court. This Maryland team really looks for one another, both in transition in the open court and in the half court in their flex offense as well as their motion offense.
Now Maryland has hit seven of their last eight shots here tonight, shooting 70%. Missed this one into Smith's hands, and here's a young man the Illini need to shake loose. He's the designated gunner for this team.
Maryland taking the Illini crowd out of this game early.
Bounce, no, yanked back down by Osborne. Osborne skied Strawberry, misses that three. Now Smith, nothing easy. Strawberry and Jones back to wide open is Carter. They lose him in transition.
Breakdown defensively by both Osby and Gist.
Jones curling again.
Their movement without the ball tonight has been excellent. Great basketball players have the ability to free themselves up for shots, using teammates, coming off of screens.
Strawberry doing a good job on Frazier. Hitting the three. Into Gist's hands. There's a lot of athletic talent on the floor for Maryland. That's obvious. Vasquez on the drive. No, but look at Gist. The running rebound coming down the middle of the lane, and it is a shocked crowd at Assembly Hall. It's 26.
The home crowd completely taken out of this game, but not a factor. Maryland completely at home, playing with the boys. Vasquez in the open court, attack the rim aggressively at 6'5", able to get a shot up, draw the help, and that opens up slamaroo for Gist.
Maryland hitting 9 of 15 from the floor. Carter dribbling out of the corner. You can see nothing easy against this. They're double up Brock, but the putback is good. Brian Carwell, a 6'11" freshman from Proviso East. The last star for Proviso East here in Champaign, D. Brown. Vasquez whipping it in underneath. And the Terrapins come back in with their 7'1" Will Bowers, a senior from Hanover, Maryland, who scored. So a couple of bigs contributing here at both ends.
Good looking jump hook, a back-to-the-basket move. See the depth that Maryland has. Even with the Beckway out, still play nine bodies.
Ice cold outside the arc. They are 0-6 from three-point range. Here's a runner from Smith, not there. Loose ball, picked up, taken away. Vasquez kicks it, and here's Brown off to the right. Maryland
needs to put some touches on the ball, get organized, try and get a post touch, play inside out.
Great feed to Carter. That was a fine pass by Brian Carwell, the freshman we spoke about out of Maywood. Still plenty of time in the first half. There's the air ball into Carter's hands. Jerry Williams going deep into his bench here in the opening half. This is big. Couldn't hit it. Off the iron. 0 of 7 from three-point range. We've got a timeout. Jones leading the way for Coach Williams with 10 points.
We're not even in the right seat.
Apocalypto means a new beginning. Unfortunately, to have a new beginning, something else has to end. It's the story of a man who is taken to be sacrificed to the gods. Against impossible odds, he's got to get back to save his family.
Mel Gibson's Apocalypto. Rated R. In theaters December 8th.
Welcome. Welcome to a brand new day. Welcome to a place where books rewrite themselves. Where you can drag and drop people wherever they want to go. Where maps are rewritten. And anyone can be famous. Where we're more powerful together than we ever could be apart. Welcome to the Human Network.
As Coach Lavin would say, Maryland is sharing the sugar, folks. 7 assists on 10 field goals.
Maryland moving the ball so well, Brent, in the half court. Let's watch Strawberry here. It's going to be a nice screen by Osby, and then a curl into the lane by Strawberry. Here's the little setup screen, a curl at 6'5". Strawberry with the one bounce step back. Nice floater. That type of execution we've seen all night long out of the Terrapins.
Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, Brent, just to add more about the chemistry and everybody chipping in here, this is something that head coach Gary Williams was looking forward to. He joked at media this year that he was so focused on the chemistry of this team, he had to look up the word synergy, as he expects to use it often this year. A good mix for this team, seniors with experience and a lot of new guys with a lot of enthusiasm, Coach Williams claims.
Aaron, you're becoming a cult figure in the Midwest. Signs saying, Aaron, marry me, flashing up there. Can you believe it, folks?
I'm blushing.
We're just happy to be part of the posse along for the ride.
That's right.
It's like being with a rock star.
We're the chauffeur. We get the sandwiches. We do the deal.
Carry the bags.
All right.
Pick up the dry cleaning.
Here's Hayes bringing it up against pressure. Trent Meacham has checked in. Both coaches are experimenting, tinkering with personnel right now. Vasquez, the young man out of Venezuela, with a strong drive and going to the left hand for the layup, 24-10.
Vasquez and Hayes, outstanding freshmen, provide size to see over the top of the defense. Both could create off the bounce playmakers.
I'm getting excited about the Maryland fan watching this young talent. I'll tell you that right now. We always know that Gary Williams teams will play hard. They always have done that. You add a little talent to that mix, and they're going to be a tough out in the ACC. Up over the top, and a foul is called. Didn't get up far enough to be turned back over to Maryland. Watch this move by Vasquez, the young man that Steve was referring to.
Just the ability to play at a nice pace, split the Illini defense, use the glass high off the square.
Hello, Ginobili of Argentina. Coming through with that left hand, split the D, looking like a former soccer player. I have no clue whether he was or not, but that was some athletic skill there. Now Brian Carlwell, the seven-footer we spoke about, the left-hander. Looks like when he spent some time in the weight room, and look there, we got a little blood over there on the Maryland sideline being tended to. So Vasquez, I wonder if he was cut when he split the D that time.
The good news for the Illini is they have three times this year come back from big deficits, but not against an opponent the quality of Maryland.
Osby, fadeaway, tough hook shot, put back, tap, no, off Osby's hands. Frazier's got it. Here come the Illini. Need to get it down to single digits. Meacham was open in the corner, but he didn't want to take that three. And just losing the handles, Brock, and here they come, and look at Osby, muscle, and now lay it in.
Big fella stretching it out in the open court. How about some broad shoulders? They list him 6'8". Looking at him in shoot around today, I don't think more than 6'6", but brings a rugged presence.
Each him on a curl. Off iron, the Illini have been cold, and Frazier reaches in for the foul. Well, we've talked about the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Now, how about tomorrow night? Michigan State and Boston College at 7 Eastern. Then Ohio State, North Carolina tomorrow at 9. I think a whole lot of us will be watching to see what this young Buckeye team can do in the hostile environment down there in North Carolina. What a fine marquee matchup that is, because Ohio State, number one in the coaches poll, right? But North Carolina is in the top five still, even though we had that upset in the Garden.
UCLA number one, right, in the AP. Ben Hallen with a heck of a team. They don't even have Ohio State Greg Oden back, and they still rank number one in the country.
He has it stripped out of bounds, Maryland ball.
Think of the guards that Ohio State has. Obviously, Daquan Cook and Mike Conley, the outstanding freshmen, but from last year's Big Ten Championship, Jamar Butler, Ron Lewis, still in the mix, Ivan Harris at the wing. That is a deep Buckeye team.
Into Pruitt's hands off the Gist miss. Frazier almost traveled. He did. Ted Valentine picked it up.
When you look at conferences, I believe the ACC is the most improved league in America. Other than Duke, every school in that conference has improved. Duke obviously trying to fill the shoes left behind by J.J. Redick and Sheldon Williams. But you look at the young talent that's come into the ACC, as well as the returning nucleuses. That is an outstanding conference and clearly the most improved league in America.
Landon Milbourne, number one. You saw him. He's a 6'7 freshman from Roswell, Georgia, from Maryland. Has checked into the game. Jamar Smith is back. Maryland turns it over. The Illini need some shooters. Meacham in. Put back. Strong. Warren Carter, the senior from Dallas. Eight minutes left here in the opening half. The Illini trying to get it back into that single-digit area, but Maryland showing us a lot of athletic ability. Jones flashes. Not there. Battling for the ball underneath. Pruitt. Smith comes out on the run. Jones picks him up. Doesn't get him daylight outside. They know how lethal he can be when he heats up. He's firing one now. In and out. That would have been huge for the Illini into Osby's hand. The three is good from Jones.
What a smooth stroke. A McDonald's All-American, come out of high school. Kind of come of age this season. The light comes on at different stages of players' careers. Coaching staff at Maryland very proud of Mike Jones' development and maturity, and what a stroke from distance.
Carter from the left baseline. Illinois has led only once in this game. That was 2-0 on a steal by Frazier. After Maryland tied it, they took a lead. They haven't relinquished it. With the Beckway out, Osby has replaced him. He's fouled. He'll be shooting free throws. We will take a break. The Illini is still stunned.
Come to the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event now through January 2nd and see all the exciting rides we have to offer. There's sure to be something for every wish list.
Tuesday. It's all about last night's game. The water cooler talk. That call. That play. That one guy who came over and ate all of your chips. But most importantly, Tuesday is about six more days till Monday night. Six more days till the fight for the playoffs heats up on ESPN Monday Night Football. Six more days till the Panthers rumble with the Eagles at 8:30. So while we fully support the memory of last night's game, don't forget what you...
Your friends about DirecTV, so why not get paid for it? Help us spread the word, and we'll give you $100. Your friends not only get DirecTV's top-ranking service, they can get a free DirecTV Plus DVR and a free portable DVD player. Then you get a $100 credit on your DirecTV bill. Got a lot of friends? No problem. There's no limit on how many referrals you can make. And for each friend you refer, you get a chance to win two round-trip tickets to Super Bowl 41 in the Refer a Friend Sweepstakes.
Earth-shaking. Groundbreaking. NBA League Pass on DirecTV will shatter your expectations with up to 40 games a week of unbelievable action. Basketball like you've never seen it before. Order NBA League Pass on DirecTV. Visit DirecTV.com or call 1-800-GET-SPORTS.
Scott Reese here in the ESPN Nerve Center. We'll be updating you on games from throughout the country throughout the night here on ESPN, including the former number one team in the land, the Florida Gators, trying to get well after that loss to Kansas, and defense into offense. Torian Green, no. Al Horford, you betcha. Gators by 11 over Southern. Brent?
All right, Scott. And here, Maryland 29, Illinois 60. Mike Jones has poured in 13 for the Terps, and James Gist, he's yanked down 5 rebounds. And Osby, the one man who replaced Ebekwe in the starting lineup, Ebekwe out with that injured ankle. He told Aaron before the game he felt that he was 50%. Coaches told us they thought he was 85%. I don't know what happened to the 35% in the meantime, but you know how coaches are. If it's not broken, you're playing, you know?
They just want to get him back to 100%. They know that for sure.
Isn't that the truth? But this young man, he's played well here tonight. 6'8". He's a junior. He's from Richmond, Virginia. Fine eye off that miss. 30-16. 6:45 to go here. North Carolina State put the ACC out by one last night. Still ahead of us, Indiana and Duke.
Good pressure extended by the Illini. Make it very difficult to get comfortable or find rhythm in your half-court offense.
Here is Pruitt. He's on the free throw line to shoot one. Let's check in with Scott Reese again for a SportsCenter 30 at 30. Scott?
All right, Brent. Eagles quarterback Donovan McNabb had surgery to repair a torn ACL. The Eagles say McNabb has a good chance to be ready for opening day 2007. And Oklahoma running back Adrian Peterson will not play Saturday in the Big 12 championship game against Nebraska. Peterson has missed 6 weeks with a broken collarbone. Details on SportsCenter 11 Eastern and constantly on ESPN News.
All right, Scott, and here, Pruitt boosts the Illini to 19, so they're down by 11, coming up on the six-minute mark of the first half. Off the iron, battle, knocked out of bounds, Illinois basketball.
On that last possession, coming out of a timeout, Coach Weber's team did a nice job of moving the basketball, probing, exploring the interior, and getting a high percentage look.
Well, some of the numbers here tonight on our stat track. That's a huge difference in the game with Maryland hitting 50%, knocking down 3 of 4. And the Illini, there hasn't been a lot of daylight from beyond the arc. I will say that Maryland and Gary Williams, they extended that tough man-to-man. Not much room, and you can see there's an open look now for Carter, draining at one of the few times that someone's been wide open, and it is down to single digits, and the Illini feel they're back in it now.
Well, you get the crowd into the game, get the adrenaline flowing, and we have to remember, this is the first big game for the Illini as well, as they find themselves without Brian Randle, one of their leaders, one of their more talented players. There are a lot of players who are trying to come of age in a big-time, bright lights environment. Nice draw and kick by Jamar Smith. Carter showing the ability from distance.
The Illini tonight are without Brian Randle. He underwent a groin surgery earlier, and they're hopeful that he will return in mid-December. He's out of Peoria, Illinois, 6'8". Those of you who follow the Illini know how important he is to the team's fortunes once the Big Ten play begins after the first of the year. Igbekwe out tonight for Maryland with that injured ankle. And with Igbekwe watching, the Illini over the last 140 have gone on their best run of the night, 8-1, to pull back to within 8. Vasquez and Gist are on the floor. Bowers stays out. He's the big man right now for the Terps. Turning baseline, missing, and here is a very active Carter yanking the rebound. Frazier is now watching, and Trent Meacham running the Illini. Carter feels it. Didn't get the bounce on that running jump shot.
Coach Weber not happy with that shot selection. Wanted to get more touches in the ball, show a little more patience. Offensive foul. The push off by Vasquez. Gave him a little red grain straight arm there.
It's interesting when you saw that graphic depicting how Maryland's shooting had slipped off. That came when Gary Williams started to tinker with his substitution pattern.
I think also the fact that the Illini settling down some, coming out of those timeouts, playing in the bright lights in a big game, adrenaline rushing, you sometimes play too fast.
Good putback. A strong performance from Warren Carter. He has been Coach Weber's man of the match here, leading this comeback. They have pulled to within 6, just what this crowd wants. And Gist goes up. Foul also on the shot. Chance for the old-fashioned 3.
Boy, Gist and Osby have had their way down low. Both clearly have spent some time in the weight room. Got that added strength and conditioning, which help with finishing on high percentage looks around the basket. Also the ability to take a hit, receive contact, and still complete the basket.
Brian Carwell back in. Pruitt will sit. He has 2 fouls, and Coach Weber did not want him to pick up number 3.
Inside of 5 minutes, if you're Bruce Weber, it's important your team stays within striking distance. If you can keep the deficit in single digits, if you're Maryland trying to extend playing on the road and trying to build in this little inside of 5 minute game here to half.
Trying to get the trap, Frazier breaks wide open, 2-on-1. And on the other side is Carwell. Brian Carwell on a putback.
Look what I found, a little garbage on the weak side, in position to take advantage.
Gist flashes. And fouled underneath is Osby. Terps ball out of bounds. 4:17 left here in the first half. ACC Big Ten Challenge, game 2. North Carolina State already a winner over Michigan. Indiana Duke coming up next. Gist off the front of the iron. Frazier. The Illini can draw to within at least 5 on this trip. Carter dumps it in. Carwell, the big fella. And he's on the free throw line. Got a little game, this youngster from Proviso East.
Good look in early offense by the Illini. The quick dump down, effective footwork. Able to get into his move very quickly and draw the foul.
So after bursting from the gate, the Terps have slowed up in Illinois. They battled back in against Gary Williams. They were once up by 15. Vasquez will set the table. Two,
comes Strawberry. McBride sticks right with him.
Illinois coach has wanted the double dribble call.
Rebound Illinois off the miss, and a foul is called. So we'll take a break. 33-27. It's a five-point game. 6 points.
See all the wonderful toys at the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event with a special lease offer on the ML350 with a 5-star crash safety rating. Now through January 2nd, there's never been a better time to get that Mercedes-Benz on your wish list.
Go, boy, go! Go, boy, go!
One big life.
Go.
Four ways to dress it.
Now stop! There ain't no more!
Have you stopped sleeping as well as you used to? Do you wake up before you want to and then just toss and turn? Maybe it's time to ask your doctor if Lunesta's right for you. For a limited time, you're invited to take the Lunesta 7-Night Challenge. Ask your doctor how to get 7 nights of Lunesta absolutely free and see if it's the sleep aid you've been looking for. Non-narcotic Lunesta helps you fall asleep quickly, so take it right before bed. Be sure you have at least 8 hours to devote to sleep before becoming active, because Lunesta will help you sleep all through the night. Until you know how you react to Lunesta, you should not drive or operate machinery. Do not take Lunesta with alcohol. Most sleep medicines carry some risk of dependency. Side effects may include unpleasant taste, headache, drowsiness, and dizziness. Hurry! The Lunesta 7-Night Challenge is only available for a limited time. Get your coupon at Lunesta.com and ask your doctor today.
Whatever it is, you can get it on eBay.
I'm Reese Davis. Coming up on the UPS Halftime Report, the Hoosiers are going to get road tested in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. We'll tell you what it'll take for Duke to stay perfect in the event. Florida State and Wisconsin are underway, two of the more undervalued players in the country going head-to-head, and the Gators trying to bounce back without one of their big stars. Got a full set joining me, Digger Phelps, Stacey Dales, Jay Billis, all coming up at halftime, Brent.
Reese, it's standing room only back there in the studio.
That's a heck of a team. We do a little weave action there. Space the floor, a little four-man motion.
Whoever talks first will never give it up.
Stacy gets to take all the shots. She's got the touch and distance.
Here's Frazier now. The Illini coming back after that foul. 33-27. Carter's been a workhorse here for the Illini. Toward that 3-10 mark. Bride brings it out. One and done, Maryland ball.
Ryan and I showed some patience on that possession, but did not get a post touch, did not get a piece of the paint, either off a penetration or a post feed. But here's an open court opportunity.
Knocked away.
To be patient on offense, but you also want to look to get a piece of the paint. The penetration, the post feeds.
Mike Jones making another fine play. Behind the back. Turn it over. Let's go back to that incident with Strawberry.
Well, the Illinois coaches were yelling for a double dribble, and they're actually correct. This crew doesn't miss many, but right here we're going to see Strawberry pick the ball up, both hands, and then go back to a dribble. That was double dribble.
Deflected. McBride went for the steal. Gist comes right back. Osby on the turnaround. And a foul on Maryland. Over Carter's back is Gist.
Fouls on Maryland, number 15, James Gist.
If you're Bruce Weber, you have to be pleased with the fact that your team has no offensive rhythm. One of your best players, Ryan Randall, still injured. And yet it's a six-point game. They can go into half, possibly cut this deficit down even more. I think they've got some of the nerves, the adrenaline rush out of the way, settle in, make some adjustments, and have a chance here on your home floor against a very talented Maryland team.
It's the ACC Big Ten Challenge. This is the second night, only one game last night, won by North Carolina State over Michigan. They took an early lead. Seven on the shot. Here comes Frazier. Tries to get into the lane. And the foul. With three on the shot clock, Carlwell is fouled. And the foul is on Osby. That's his second.
We talked about getting a piece of the paint, Brent, either through post feeds or penetration. We see Frazier get into the lane, draw defense, a nice dump off to Carlwell. And of course, Gary Williams thought it was a clean block. So both coaches demonstrative, animated on the sidelines here when communicating with the officials. This is a good crew.
It's too quiet for a freshman. You gotta have a little buzz in the arena. They're standing in the crowd in Champaign, 16,000 plus. Waiting to see what kind of the identity the Illini will reach in the post-D. Brown era. So Carlwell has scored eight off Coach Weber's bench. Now it is a five. Vasquez, ugly looking three. Illini ball. They can actually take a lead before the intermission with 1:39 to go after trailing by 15.
Well, there is a precedent for the Illini comebacks this year. That has been one of their early characteristics as a team. Not ideal. They've fallen behind, but shown the resiliency to come back in games and find a way to win.
Probing for that open look. Carlwell whipping it back outside. Now five on the shot. Now they got to go. Meacham off balance. Knows the clock was running down. Maryland ball. But the Terps have missed 14 of their last 18 shots. Bowers back on the floor. With a back way out. Trying to give him the big who can play. Vasquez left hand in and out. There's Bowers battling back. Loose. Illini ball. Final 30 seconds of the opening half. Here's Frazier. Tap back by Carter. Comes back again. Wraparounds high. Maryland. Bowers yanks it away. Now the final 19. Open look. Vasquez. Goes against the Terps. It's on Gist. That's his second. So that's the eighth team foul on Maryland, four on Illinois.
Illini will go for one shot here, Brent, but different than past years, a bit of a mystery in terms of what they will do. Last year it would have been Augustine and D. Brown in a two-man game, maybe a high pick and roll. In years past, Darren Williams or Luther Head involved. But here, as they still try and find an identity, it looks like Carter and Frazier in a little two-man game, a little dribble handoff weave action.
Inside to the left-hander at the buzzer. A five-point lead, but for Bruce Weber, the Illini, it could have been a lot worse. Maryland went out by 15, 29-14, and then the Illini close out the half 14-4 to make a stand. And let's check in with Aaron.
Coach, come out of the gates quick. How did the Illini manage to slow you down?
Well, you know, we're not going to beat them by 15 here, so we played great early. Now we got to win the game. We're up 5 at halftime, and we got to get our composure back a little bit. Some of our young guys got a little crazy there, and we missed some shots. We didn't miss any easy shots early. We did after a while, so we got to get back to playing like we did early.
How has having a Beckway on the bench affected you tonight?
Well, it's one man we don't have in a rotation, plus he's been our leading shot blocker and our leading scorer in a lot of games, so it obviously affects us. But, you know, we're a team, and we have to try to overcome that.
Thanks, Coach. Brent.
All right, Aaron, thank you very much. 33-28, Maryland leads it. Time now for the UPS halftime report. And Reese has got a full house. Digger, Jay, and Stacy, take it away, Reese.
Only thing missing here, Brent, the face paint. Don't have any of that. Gary Williams, very practical, Jay, about this. Knew he wasn't going to blow Illinois out there. They've won 51 straight non-conference games at home. But how did the Illini get the momentum turned back in their favor?
Well, I think Maryland helped them out with that a little bit. Maryland's got some young guards, and they came down in key situations, took some bad shots and some quick shots, and that led to a few runouts that got Illinois some easy baskets and got the Illini settled down. And once you score a few easy baskets, that's when your defense starts to pick up a little bit, and that's exactly what happened with Illinois. But I think you can tell by watching this Maryland team play this year that it's a different kind of team. It's a team more receptive, a team that listens better, and a team that is playing Gary Williams' style. And you can tell he really likes coaching these young kids.
Well, and Jay, I think Illinois made a great adjustment, and that was on the offensive end. And basketball is really, you guys know, it's a very simple game. If you get the ball to the big guys inside, it opens up opportunities on the outside. They didn't shoot a free throw, Illinois, until 9:47 in the first half. Once they got the ball inside, get to the free throw line, then Warren Carter strokes a three from the outside.
But I think this goes to where Illinois really missed D. Brown. And this is the first big game without a D. Brown running the show the way he did the last 2 years for Illinois. So they start the game out shooting 3-for-12 because they were rushing shots, weren't getting on the glass. But then their defense got it going. And when you can take Maryland and they miss 16 or last 20 shots before halftime, this is what's got the difference going for Illinois. Maryland needs a wake-up call halftime.
It's still a 5-point lead for the Terrapins right now. The ACC, they've controlled the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Big Ten trying to get a win at home. There's a devil of a challenge on the road for a Big Ten team tonight at Cameron Indoor. We'll look ahead to Indiana and Duke in just a little while.
The ACC Big Ten Challenge, presented by Papa John's, is brought to you by Mercedes-Benz, located on the web at mbusa.com, and John Hancock. The future is yours.
Wonderful toys at the Mercedes-Benz Winter Event. With a special lease offer on the 7-passenger GL450, the 2007 Motor Trend Sport Utility of the Year, now through January 2nd. There's never been a better time to get that Mercedes-Benz on your wish list.
I've always wanted a farm, like my grandparents used to have. With a stable, you know, for the horses. A place where everyone can get together. Kids, grandkids, all my cousins, the whole family. And then pass it on to all the generations that come after me.
You once made a promise to yourself about your future. At John Hancock, we have the products you need to help build, protect, and sustain the future you've always wanted. John Hancock, the future is yours.
Guys looking to go high def. Our pledge is to help you wow them with the ultimate system.
Like the latest from LG. LG TVs let you see and feel everything in true digital reality. Now save up to $300 when you buy an LG TV with any home theater installation. Only at Best Buy.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
The home team, Illinois, got off to a very slow start but closed the half against Maryland on a 14-4 run. Warren Carter finishing there. 5-point lead for the Terrapins at the break. Florida State and Wisconsin. Bo Ryan's just joined the 500-win club. Wisconsin 76-5 at home under him. Cameron Taylor, Jake.
Tough place to win, Wisconsin. Cameron Taylor, one of the better guards in the Big Ten. You've got to be ready to guard every single screen, and Florida State has not been ready going up top to Alondo Tucker.
And then Greg Steensma would find Alondo Tucker, who finishes with a jam.
Tucker's tough. When he gets going inside, outside, he's their complete player.
Tucker started quickly. Al Thornton has not. The Florida State star only with a single bucket in the early going. Indiana and Duke, 9 o'clock Eastern time on ESPN HD. And then more from the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Miami and Northwestern at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN 2 HD. The Indiana-Duke matchup, the marquee one. Remember the great game last year in which Marco Killingsworth scored 34 points. Series is tied up at 3, Duke winning that game a year ago. In fact, Duke has never lost a game in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. But what Duke needs to do in the early going to hold off Indiana at home, get some good play from their point guard.
Well, they do, and Greg Paulus needs to become a leader for this team. He's only averaging about 25 minutes. I think Coach K wants him to get up there at about 33 or 34 minutes. He's a quality player, but they're having to play point guard by committee right now. This is a team that's still seeking its identity, and Paulus is not starting for this team right now. Henderson is starting, and I think that as Paulus gets more experience, he's going to be critical for this Duke team, and he's coming off the bench. He's going to increase those minutes, but I think Coach Krzyzewski just trying to wane him into the system a little bit without Redick back there, and he's having to make a lot more decisions this year. Decision-making is critical, Reese.
They're still trying to find their identity, too, with the loss
identity,
of Redick.
Identity, capital
guys.
Y. Yeah.
And Josh McRoberts is a guy that Krzyzewski's going to count on to provide some offense right now.
I think Josh McRoberts has to be their best player. He's supremely talented. He's a left-hander. He can score in the post. He runs the floor very well. Gets a lot of points off of stick backs. He's shooting over 90% from the free throw line. What he's got to do is get to the line even more. He's been playing on the perimeter a little bit more than you would expect for a guy his size because he is such a good ball handler and such a really terrific passer. But I think he's got to get down to the post a little bit more. And the free throw line is going to be a big issue in this game against Indiana because Indiana giving up to its opponents 22 free throw attempts per game. They're going to have to play good defense without fouling. Otherwise, Duke is going to make a living at the free throw line in this one.
This game last year, Indiana really controlled the inside. That was with Killingsworth. No Marco Killingsworth this time. They do have DJ White.
They do have DJ White if he stays out of foul trouble. And this has been his problem. And I think when he has that consistency, they can go to him inside. And that's going to be the challenge for McRoberts. Now, McRoberts was only 4 for 16 in that Marquette loss. So to me, it's going to be how do you attack Duke, go after DJ White inside, get him in foul trouble. And I think that's got to be battle, Jay, because you know Duke and Coach K, he wants to put that in a position where if we get him in trouble, there goes the rebounding and inside play.
Yeah, and I think they're worried. They need to play really good defense. Duke does, and turn Indiana over. If they're not able to turn them over and get some easy scores, it's going to be a grinded-out game, and that's an Indiana advantage.
Indiana and Duke, 9 o'clock Eastern time, part of the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Hoosiers trying to give the Devils their first loss. A couple of SEC heavyweights trying to bounce back and find themselves. Gators doing so a little shorthanded. We'll tell you about it when we come back.
UPS, covering more of Europe before noon than anyone. UPS, covering more ground faster than ever.
Anytime. Okay. Ease off the clutch, ease on.
Don't
okay,
say
no.
anything.
Don't do that.
One more time.
Ease off the clutch.
Easing right now. Easing.
Who would you give a Volvo to? Tell us at volvocars.us.
Lease a new 2007 Volvo S40 for $259 a month for 36 months.
Good oral health is part of your overall health. Philips Sonicare.
Sonicare improves your oral health. Its patented sonic technology creates dynamic cleaning action, getting deep between the teeth and along the gum line for a healthier mouth guaranteed. It makes sense Sonicare is the power toothbrush brand most used and recommended by dental professionals. Sonicare. Simplicity is brushing your teeth and taking care of your body.
Edward Wilson left a world of privilege.
My orders came. I'll be going overseas.
For a world at war.
You're going to have to learn the system of intelligence.
It's a different kind of war with different enemies.
For the next three decades, he helped build the most powerful covert agency in the world.
The CIA.
And their nasty little secrets.
You're the guys that scare me. You're the people that make big wars.
Yeah, we make sure the wars are small ones.
The Good Shepherd, rated R, in theaters Friday, December 22nd.
It's time to feel free with New Chase Freedom. Feel free to choose points for rewards like travel.
I'm free to do what I want.
Or feel free to choose cash back.
I'm free.
Then feel free to change back again. Without losing a thing. That's freedom. That's Chase Freedom. Get it free at chase.com/freedom.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Gators coming off their loss to Kansas. No Corey Brewer, who has mono, but they do have Joakim Noah against Southern.
Well, and they've done a fabulous job on the offensive glass. 12 offensive boards, and Joakim right there has 4 already in this game. 10 points in the paint for Florida in the first half.
He missed the free throw. Gators up by 4, and just talent coming from everywhere. Maurice Spates with the block. Torian Green going all the way, but did someone mention offensive rebound? Al Horford there to flush it. Rob Spivory's team getting hammered, but they'll get the check. 36-16 final. Charleston and Kentucky.
Score.
Tubby. Score. Jay, is it the Crusade to score?
Score.
Kentucky had a tough time scoring as the game started, but they really found their stride later in the game by going inside to Randolph Morris. Their defense has been outstanding against a very good Charleston team led by Dante Draper.
Draper averaging 21 points per game. You saw him get an assist to McCandice earlier. Sheree Stevenson finishing there. Wildcats up by a dozen at halftime. Second half, just around the corner, Mike Jones with a pretty stroke for Maryland. Terrapin started quickly. Now can they regain that momentum and energy? Second half, just around the corner.
The ACC Big Ten Challenge is presented by Papa John's. Order pizza online 24 hours a day at papajohns.com. And Volvo. Experience the full line of 2007 Volvos. Who would you give a Volvo to? Volvo for life.
Superman Pan Pizza is here!
It's big news! Papa John's Superman Pan Pizza, piled high with the works. 7 tasty toppings. Call now or order online and get a large Superman Pan Pizza for $12.99. $12.99, including a $3 coupon for Superman Returns on DVD.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
They were really good, and they lived in the house. Uh-huh. Wanted to change the color of him, and it has legs, and I don't know what it is. And just worms and some bugs,
but his head is so tiny.
Who would you give a Volvo to? Tell us at VolvoCars.us.
Lease a new 2007 Volvo XC90 3.2 front-wheel drive for $359 a month for 24 months.
It's the most magical time of the year. Experience advanced performance and technology at Acura's Drive Home for the Holidays sales opportunity. Take advantage of special financing on select Acura models for well-qualified customers.
It's the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's. Maryland once up by 15, leads it by 5, 33-28. They have forged that lead without a Pekwe. Their injured big man out with an ankle, missing tonight. And suddenly, Coach, it is the big men of the Fighting Illini who have started to step up here.
Well, Warren Carter, 13 points and 10 rebounds, a double-double in the first half. So early, it was Mike Jones on fire for the Terrapins, but late Warren Carter carrying the Illini. Look at Jones from long range. Rip and let it rip from distance, and then showing a little ability here off the handoff action with the one bounce high lift. Textbook technique. And then Carter, so aggressive, so active, using his length, his foot speed to get on the glass, slash to the basket for easy putbacks, and even showed the ability to step away.
Let's check in with Aaron.
Well, Brent, I had a chance to speak with head coach Bruce Weber for the Illini. He said shot selection is what is hurting the Illini the most. He said his senior, Rich McBride, just coming off the suspension, said he's not in a rhythm right now and he's trying to win the game. So the difference, the Illini, 1-for-11 from 3-point for the Maryland Terrapins. They're 3-for-5. He says that's the difference.
And there are the droughts for both teams in this game. And you mentioned, Aaron, you mentioned Rich McBride. He missed all three of his attempts in the first half, all three from beyond the arc. So we've got a timeout here, 33-28, a quickie.
The ACC Big Ten Challenge, tonight at 9 on ESPN.
Anytime. Okay.
Oops.
Okay. Ease off the clutch. Ease on.
Don't say anything.
Don't do that.
Don't do that.
One more time. Ease off the clutch.
Easing right now. Easing.
Who would you give a Volvo to? Tell us at volvocars.us.
Lease a new 2007 Volvo S40 for $259 a month for 36 months.
Cholesterol. It can come from fettuccine Alfredo, but also from your grandpa Alfredo, from barbecue ribs, and from your grandma Barbie. A healthy diet is important. When that's not enough, adding Vitorin can help. Cholesterol comes from two sources, food and family. Vitorin treats two sources. Only Vitorin helps block the absorption of cholesterol from food and reduces the cholesterol your body makes naturally based on family history. Vitorin was also proven in clinical studies to lower bad cholesterol more than Lipitor alone. Vitorin is not for everyone, including people with liver problems, women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. Unexplained muscle pain or weakness could be a sign of a rare but serious side effect. Vitorin may interact with other medicines or certain foods, increasing your risk of getting this serious side effect. Simple blood tests are needed to check for liver problems. So eat right, stay active. But if that's not enough, ask your doctor about adding Vitorin, two sources of cholesterol. Treat them both with Vitorin.
Steve, you and I have seen a lot of timeouts, but never before without a second ticking off the clock, my friend.
That's called burning an early one.
Bruce Weber jumped up and took one. The Illini with the first trip, and Carter is knocked down. No harm, no foul. He's back up. Frazier brings it down. Meacham will open the second half for the Illini, the young man from Champaign. Brock will not. Brock started the game for them. Feed Pruitt, who has two fouls for the Illini, cut off at the baseline, and he traveled. Pruitt struggling, Sean Pruitt turning it over. Now Maryland's first possession of the second half. Gist was 4 of 9, Jones 5 of 8, leading the way. Strawberry, struggling a bit, was only 1 of 5 from the floor. Osby, off iron, was passing the ball and got it too high, too far. motion offense. Searching for the good shot. Pruitt coming again, and this time successful.
You have to like that. They go right back to him, a confidence builder. First possession on his catch, he travels. You come back to the big fella, throw him a bone, try and build his confidence. You're going to need him late in the game.
Strawberry stripped by Meacham. Meacham contributes. 3-on-1, and he palmed it. Turned it over on the dribble.
Well, a proverbial point of emphasis call. Hank Nichols this year, always discussing the talking points of officiating, and they have gotten on top of that ball. I didn't see it as clearly as
I think it came
Teddy
early.
Valentine did.
I thought the call came late, Steve, and it was one of the first times he put it down. And, you know, Ted just couldn't get the whistle blown in time is how I kind of saw that.
If you're a coach in the sidelines, you have these three officials on the floor.
Yeah, it's a big-time crew. I agree.
You can let them do their job.
Traveling. 33-30. And here is Abikwe. Kenny Abikwe came in average about a dozen a game. Hitting 50%. Out with that ankle injury. This has been a turnover marred game. We've had five turnovers already here in the early going. In underneath, and Pruitt's on the free throw line. He got mugged.
Three consecutive possessions. The Illini have dumped the ball down to Pruitt. Two of those three, something productive has come from those post catches. Foul opportunity shooting here.
Bowers ready to check in. So the loss of Abekwe certainly did not affect the Terps how they started the game. But as it wears on, there's no question now. With Osby, a little bit undersized, forced to the sideline with his third personal. And Will Bowers, the 7'1" senior on the floor. So Illinois probing away at the absence of Abekwe, sticking with their original plan. And now down by two. Bowers comes out high. Need to set a high screen, pick and roll. Carter switches on him. Back outside, Jones off the iron, battle rebound, out of bounds, Illinois.
One of the intriguing aspects of basketball is the elusive rhythm that teams are always trying to establish in their offense. And clearly the advantage now is swung to the Illini. Early in the game, Maryland had their offensive rhythm, their confidence, their swagger. Now you see the Illini with that same confidence, rhythm, and swagger.
Second half. Knocked away into the backcourt. Carter goes back to recover it. Using the push-off hand, regains it. Got to pick his dribble up. That was awkward. Here comes Frazier. Inside to Pruitt. Took an extra dribble. Made it tougher than it should have been. Tied at 33. Illinois has led for only 132. Now it's Gary Williams wanting a timeout. Not happy.
Boy, Pruitt getting all the touches, all the opportunities, Brent. And this crowd has responded, brought to their feet. You see Frazier with the penetration and the spin move in traffic among the trees. Good finish.
Have you noticed how when he shoots, he sort of releases quickly?
There is a quick release, a little flick there.
Scouts, they'll pick up on that now.
Off the fingertips.
On Pruitt. Be ready because it's going to be flipped and it's somewhat low. You know, a good big-time defender is going to move in on that shot. And a reminder now, the ACC Big Ten Challenge continues on ESPN and ESPN2. There's our schedule right after us on ESPN. Indiana against Duke from Cameron. And then on ESPN2, Miami into Evanston to play Northwestern. Maryland basketball. The Illini set up the pressure, deadlocked at 33. Illinois' only lead came on Frazier's steal as the game was beginning. Bowers backs in, turns, paint, flashes out, off Carter, out of bounds, Maryland ball.
It's a good aggressive mistake, an aggressive turnover by the Illini.
Maryland looking for its first field goal, Steve, in the last 7 minutes and 45 seconds. Got it. They end the drought. Vasquez.
Nice little runner. Good lift on his shot.
Drop it in. Pruitt. That left hand, and it's rejected underneath that time. Loose ball, knocked away by Carter. Maryland ball, good call.
Bruce Weber tries to build this team and develop an identity, find ways to generate points offensively with injuries and younger players stepping in. Defense has to be the constant.
This is wonderful. Carter Gimpy going back down. Bruce Weber, he didn't see it, even though he was looking right at it. And on the turnaround, Gist. And it's a 4-point Terp lead.
And Maryland did a nice job there of sniffing out that matchup. Talking about Carter moving nimbly there on his maybe an ankle or a foot. And went right at him.
Here's Frazier. Beecham's three. Trent Beecham, redshirt sophomore from right here in Champaign, pulls the Illini back to within one.
Beecham getting extended minutes, bringing the ball up the floor some. Catch and shoot opportunity.
The Illini have done an excellent job on Strawberry in this game here tonight. We're going to take a break. Maryland's 15-point lead has evaporated. It's one.
When I want the last shot, when I know I've already made it.
Hey, baby.
Hey, what's up?
Not much. Just wanted to talk to the most beautiful girl in the world, that's all.
That's sweet.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's just nice to know that I'm the only man in your world. I am the only man in your world, right? Baby?
Switch to singular with the fewest dropped calls.
Maybe is it Earl?
Now buy a Samsung phone and get 3 free.
Cat got your tongue? Earl got your tongue?
CokeRewards.com.
Hi, can I help you?
Yes. Will you pretend you're my wife? Great. Come on.
Happy holidays, sweetheart. Something else?
Yeah, maybe not romantic enough.
Oh, pretty.
At Lowe's, we're happy to help you find the perfect holiday gift for everyone on your list.
What do you think?
Perfect.
Yes.
Lowe's, let's build something together.
Will you be my father-in-law?
A gift card.
Scott Reese with a SportsCenter in-game update. ECC Big Ten Challenge over on ESPN2. Florida State and Wisconsin. The Badgers go inside with Michael Flowers. Pretty lay-in for two of his 4 points. And then the Badgers go outside with Conference Player of the Year candidate Orlando Tucker knocking down the triple. Right now, Wisconsin by 7 over the Seminoles. Dave?
Warren Carter, who has the double-double in the first half, is going to sit for a while. Ice being applied to the right knee. 13 points, 10 rebounds. So we'll see how the Illini do with him watching right now. Hayes loses it into Pruitt's hands. Jamar Smith back on the floor.
Better organization, better spacing, better organization, better structure offensively by the Illini in this half.
Frazier battling his way in. Illinois ball.
Tough double clutch shot by Frazier. Be better off sitting down, 2-foot jump stop, and kicking that ball back out to the perimeter.
Looking to shake a shooter loose here.
Really continue to probe the post.
Pruitt turns, wants to get to the left hand. His preferred spot would be on the other block, back and down and going to the left hand if he wants to turn baseline, because he loves that left hand.
On that post catch, he should have kicked the ball back out, reestablished the post. I'm going to start calling the Illini to come back kids, Brent. They trail Jackson State by 14, Florida A&M by 7, Miami of Ohio by 16. You see a nice hook by Bowers there. Bradley by 11, and then in this game they were down 15. So consistently in the racing form, they have come back on opponents.
Carter back up. He told the staff ready to go. The ice was applied to the knee, so he will check back in with Tarwell. Three in and out. Frazier goes to save it. And it's Maryland basketball as the two big men check back in for the Illini. Maryland leading it by 39-36 for Coach Williams.
Maryland came into this game averaging 83 points a game. This tempo clearly favors the Illini, more comfortable playing in a methodical or grinding half-court game. They like to opportunity run. We've seen them put up big numbers and points over the years, but this team's still finding their offensive identity.
Knocked away from Gist. McBride, this time, yes. Tied at 39.
Nice hot potato on the perimeter by the Illini, finding the open man.
That's a stroke that Gary Williams did not want to see from McBride. They had him real quiet in the first half. Gist not there, but tracked down by Strawberry, and they have handled Strawberry. Vasquez on a runner. Foul is called. Carwell. Talked about Strawberry. He's only one of five, Steve, in this game.
Well, that's how Bruce Weber has had success throughout his career. He's a disciple of Gene Cady. Always solid defensively as an assistant for years at Purdue, at Southern Illinois, as he built that program. And again, with the Fighting Illini, their defense is the baseline they build their program from. They get their fast break, open court opportunities off their defense. Nights where they struggle offensively, as they did in the first half, they'll hang around and have a chance to win because of their solid half-court defensive principles.
Steve, how much of the two failed NCAA runs by Gary Williams can be blamed on the turnover on his coaching staff? I was thinking as I looked at the assistants how few of these fellows we have seen through the years over there. We used to recognize all the assistants.
In a sense, they're a victim of their own success. They had such great success, 11 straight NCAA tournaments, 7 Sweet 16s, a Final Four, a national championship, and with that success, they lost players early to the NBA. Gary Williams' assistants moved on, like Dave Dickerson, and we saw Chuck Drysdale there, the son of Lefty Drysdale, but Dave Dickerson moved on as a head coach at Tulane, and is that other fine assistant coaches. So a combination of losing assistants, which breaks up that continuity or stability of a program, and losing players early to the NBA, then you miss on a couple recruits, or you have a class that doesn't have great chemistry or plays a little bit selfish, as Coach Williams and the staff felt the last 2 years they did, you can all of a sudden miss a couple tournaments. But they are back.
Cassini Beckway here tonight because of an injured ankle, and it's a one-point Maryland lead. Carter on the run, and now heating up, Calvin Brock. So Brock nails the three. Illinois with its first lead since the opening of the game.
Illinois came into the game, Brent, shooting 40% from the three-point line, 1 of 11 in the first half, but they have caught fire, a big part of their arsenal, attacking the three-point line.
Vasquez loses it, saves it. Vasquez, not this time, tracked down by Meacham.
Good help on their half-court defense.
So the Carter save it. He went for the timeout. We'll take a break. With the timeout, we'll take it.
Hey, want a Bud Light?
Yeah.
Whoa. Rubber floors. Just had them installed. Now we'll never break a Bud Light. Oh, nice. Remote.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Hi. Too much bounce. Maybe.
Tuesday. It's all about last night's game. The water cooler talk. That call. That play. That one guy who came over and ate all of your chips. But most importantly, Tuesday is about six more days till Monday night. Six more days till the fight for the playoffs heats up on ESPN Monday Night Football. Six more days till the Panthers rumble with the Eagles at 8:30. So while we fully support the memory of last night's game, don't forget what you have to look forward to.
DirecTV Original Programming presents Songs of Praise for Christmas. The spirit of Songs of Praise for Easter returns with the most inspirational choirs and performing artists from across the nation. Celebrate the true meaning of Christmas with hosts Amy Grant and Daryl Waltrip. Songs of Praise for Christmas, now showing through New Year's Eve on Channel 103, exclusively on DirecTV.
That's the way to move without missing a beat.
I like the way you move.
This telecast available on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. Well, Gary Williams once was a head coach at Ohio State, so he knows a lot about atmosphere in Assembly Hall.
It's a great atmosphere. I've always enjoyed playing on other teams' home courts. I've been lucky enough to coach in the Big East, the Big Ten, and now the ACC, so I've seen most of the tough home courts, and you know, it's just a great feeling to play well in this type of situation tonight.
And they were up by 15 in the first half. That disappeared before the intermission, and now the Illini have come all the way back. They lead at 42-40, 11:29 to go.
Illini have done a nice job of balancing their offensive attack, getting touches for Pruitt on the block, 3 of 4 from the three-point line.
Brown on the floor for the Terps. He played briefly in the first half, a turnover immediately. Meacham running the floor, feeds Brock. Brock is at the free throw line. Well, let's check in with Scott Reese for a SportsCenter 30 at 30. Scott.
All right, Brent, Eagles quarterback Donovan McNabb had surgery to repair his torn ACL today. The Eagles say McNabb has a good chance to be ready for opening day of 2007. College football, Oklahoma running back Adrian Peterson will not play in Saturday's Big 12 title game against Nebraska. He's been out with a broken collarbone, but they do expect Peterson back for the Sooners bowl game. Details on SportsCenter, 11 Eastern. Now back to Champaign. Yes.
All right, Reese and Steve, here's a bulletin from the West Coast. UCLA says they will show up on Saturday. You know what that rivalry is like out there between UCLA and USC when those two schools go at it.
Well, so much pride. You have so many alumni, fans, obviously players who are competing that grew up in the Southern California area, who reside in the Southern California area, and the momentum that builds to that game. It is a special rivalry.
So the Illini build their first four-point margin of the night with 11 minutes to go. Hayes coming baseline, left hand.
Hayes does a nice job of playing with the right pace, not scampering, not out of control. Sometimes you'll see young players in pressure-packed conditions get scampering like a hamster. For a freshman, Hayes very poised with the ball in his hands.
McBride under pressure fires a three. Tap, no. Tap again by Brock. Didn't have it. Loose ball out of bound. Maryland basketball. Osby back on the floor for the Terps. Maryland looking for the tying hoop or the go-ahead with the three. Out of bounds. Turn it over on the jump pass that time by Jones.
That's the tough thing about jumping in the air to make a pass.
You
want to stay down on your feet.
Shoot the ball.
Yeah,
that's what he wanted. Absolutely.
We're talking about staffs, Brent. Right now, Michael Adams is on the staff at Maryland, played for Gary Williams at Boston College, knows what Coach Williams expects. Chuck Trizel, Lefty's son, and also Keith Booth, who played for Gary at Maryland. So he's got a couple former players of his, which is so important, an extension. Understand what's expected, the system, the philosophy, each of them. Take it to the hole, get that out.
Osby with a good block, and Vasquez pushing foul call. Well, the ACC Big Ten Challenge continues tomorrow night on ESPN at Michigan State, Boston College. That's the Lid Lifter at 7 to be followed by the Buckeyes to play the Tar Heels, a major, major confrontation in Ohio State. Really, their biggest game so far of the year. All those talented freshmen, minus Greg Oden. We'll see what kind of a game they come up with against Tyler Hansbrough and the Tar Heels tomorrow night. Loose ball knocked out of bounds. And we'll see. Maryland will come back to play a little defense here. And Frazier, who thought it was going the other way, has to hustle back to take it out of bounds. Illini up two now. Final 10 minutes of regulation. Carter has been quieter here in the second half. Over the top, wanted Sean Pruitt. Pruitt with a size advantage, muscling in, won't stay down.
Tough angle, too far under the basket on his post catch.
Now Osby has it knocked away by Carter. Loose, here comes Frazier. Good open floor player. Kicks now to Brock for the land. Back at the other end, foul goes against Illinois.
One of the rare opportunities for Strawberry in the open court. That's a credit to the Illini scouting and their solid defensive schemes. Strawberry, a player that thrives, slashing to the basket, getting out in the open court, coming into the game at the most free throw attempts of any player on the Terps roster, which tells you he's an aggressive player that likes to attack the rim. But tonight, not many opportunities against this solid half-court defense of the Illini.
Maryland, their record ACC Big Ten Challenge, and three of their seven have gone into overtime. So if they follow form, they would lose tonight because it's an every other year. However, there's a lot of time left to play here. Rattles out into Pruitt's hand. With a Beckway on the bench, Illinois' Steve with that size advantage. And so that's why Bowers has seen quite a few minutes here tonight. He's down there with Pruitt. Put a big body on him.
See the Illini playing at a bit more of a deliberate tempo. They've slowed down. They're a little bit in a hurry in the first half. This half, they've caught their breath, settled in to a better rhythm offensively, and that's a credit to Coach Weber and his staff. We saw it late in the first half, and it's carried over into this second half. A different Illini team.
Strawberry picking up the personal. Get it inbounds to Pruitt. Here's Carter from deep in the corner. Now Jamar Smith back on the floor. He's been quiet. Missed a half dozen games. Brock very active late. Good pass to Carter. Wouldn't stay down, but Pruitt! Biggest lead of the night, 48-43. Having a strong second half is Pruitt. Timeout is called. Maryland. The absence of a Beckway starting to tell as Pruitt, 7 of his 10 points here in the second half. The Illini with an advantage with the bigs.
Well, Pruitt in the second half, much better ball movement by the Illini, and the slashing cut by Carter to the rim draws the defense and allows Pruitt from the weak side to clean up the garbage. Look what I found. Flush it home, big fella.
Illinois' non-conference home win streak at 51. The coach again, the last time they lost a non-conference game here, Lon Kruger. And you think about their regular season non-conference record overall, road and home. They've won 40 consecutive games. Bruce Weber was beaten by Providence 70-51, so they have been in the months of November and December.
You know, even as this young Illini team finds their identity, they are a difficult team to prepare for because they're so balanced. They have 6 players in double figures, and McBride coming into the game was at 9.7, Brent. So nearly 7 players averaging double figures. And that makes it tough in terms of keying on one particular player. And we've seen it tonight, the balanced in both half scoring.
You know, this year marks the inaugural year of the Crush Kids program. There's the terrific fans here, Orange Crush. They work with youngsters. They've got a couple of terminally ill children from an area hospital here tonight. And those youngsters are having the time of their life coming here to watch the Illini play Maryland. What a great group of youngsters who work in charity in the Champaign area. And what a terrific shot by the Venezuelan. Vasquez knocking it down, pulls Maryland to within 2.
Great offensive possession out of the timeout. Timeout well designed by Gary Williams. Again, movement without the ball. Vasquez taking advantage.
And at the other end, it's that man again, number 55. He's a junior from Aurora, Illinois. 8 minutes to go. Vasquez works in low and 1.
We're talking about the movement without the ball. Vasquez on the last possession, popping open for a 3-point shot, now posting up using his 6'5" size down low and not afraid to use the glass. A little kiss, takes the hit, the finish.
50-46.
Where being here is being there. Welcome to the Human Network.
Everyone is talking about one thing.
Pirates.
Pirates.
Pirates!
On December 5th.
We have our heading.
The biggest movie event of the decade. Is yours the treasure?
Welcome aboard.
Johnny Depp.
Hey, fish bite!
Of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Jest. Own it on Disney DVD December 5th.
Hey guys.
Hey
stand up.
We have a little announcement to make. We both,
He went to Jared.
Oh, he went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared?
He went to Jared?
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry has 5 times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores, from the classic to the contemporary, so you'll find the perfect ring.
He went to Jared.
I know. He went to Jared.
Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Center in-game update, ACC Big Ten Challenge over on ESPNU, Penn State and Georgia Tech, Javaris Crittenden, the pilfer, and the push, and the Yellow Jackets up by 6 as we approach 3 to go in the first half. And of course, after your game in Champaign, it'll be Dick Vitale at the microphone. You know he's getting them fired up at Cameron, Indiana, and Duke, 9 o'clock Eastern Time, guys.
Dickie B is ready to go at Cameron, and here it is 50-48. They conferred with the officials during that timeout, and the basket did count. Ted's signal was not emphatic about that, so the scorer had to double-check, and Vasquez knocks down, and it's a one-point game on the old-fashioned three-point play. But the story for Maryland is how quiet Strawberry's been here tonight. He came in averaging 16 points a game.
Talk about a tremendous learning opportunity, Brent, for the Maryland freshmen, Vasquez and Hayes. A little international flavor here by Vasquez from long range, moving well without the ball, catch and shoot opportunity, and then showing he has the ability to post up, play with his back to the basket, take the contact down low, and still finish for the old-fashioned three-point play, and that allowed Maryland to set their defense off the free throw and force the Illini into a timeout.
You know, we talked to Gary Williams about the value of Strawberry to this Maryland team, and here's what he said.
I think his leadership a lot of times is by the way he plays. You know, some guys clap a lot and they yell a lot during timeouts, and, you know, that's fine. But really, what you do on the court determines how good of a leader you are, and he's really got it done so far this year.
So he's one of the coach's favorites, as you could tell by that soundbite. 1 of 5, though, from the field, and Illinois has certainly made him the focus of their defense when you talk about important things here. And the other important thing is the fact that Ebekwe has not played at all, and the Illini have started to take advantage of that down low. Bowers is going to try it. He's going to stay in there low, but they really want him in that low zone as he moves over on Carter in time, gets away with it.
Hostile environment of Assembly Hall, Brent, a great opportunity to come of age for these younger Maryland guards. They're going to be in the ACC on the road. They'll now have this game as a reference point.
Feeding Bowers, and he double dribbled. Now, frustrated, you know, Gary can't reach over there and send Ebekwe back onto the floor. Illinois shooting threes much better. Pruitt solid here in the second half. Carter's been very active after dominating the first half. Knocked away by Strawberry, out of bounds. 15 on the shot. Jones back in, Meacham back in. Brock sits, Hayes sits.
Maryland guards would be wise to get Strawberry involved, get him some touches coming down the stretch. You want your senior and leading scorer feeling good and in the flow. Not to force the action, but look for him.
You can see how cold Jones has been. The tap back in. No, again, yes. John Pruitt comes up big here in the second half. Osby will go back in and try him. That's your key matchup for the Illini. Vasquez on the drive. Into Carter. Scoring.
Boy, tough shot. A nifty move. Little dipsy-do. Gets the soft carom. Another chance at an old-fashioned three-point play by Vasquez. He does have a tremendous feel for the game. You can sense that international flavor the coaching staff was talking about. Made that shot look a lot easier than it actually was. A little flavor there, a little spice, a little hot sauce.
So Osby replaces Bowers underneath. Illinois up by one. 6 minutes here in regulation. Has to get rid of a bad pass. Got hung up in the air. McBride did.
Second time we've seen that tonight. Jumping in the air to make a pass. Left with no options.
Got the roll. Jones ends the drought. Deflected by Maryland. On the steal. Here he comes. Strawberry contributing. Off the glass. So on a quiet night, he comes up huge to make it 55-52 now.
One of the few times we've seen a quick spurt in the second half here by Maryland.
Strawberry did it with his defense after the Jones field goal.
I like the fact that Strawberry hasn't forced Brent on a night where he's not in the flow offensively, yet still finding ways to contribute. With defense.
The three by McBride coming off of his mistake. Deadlocks it at 55.
Well, Strawberry that time got caught trailing McBride.
Vasquez kick corner. Jones again comes back. He drains a three.
Rhythm shooter. Jones with a picture perfect textbook technique. The release off the middle three fingers. Great backspin. Jones a senior, Strawberry senior, upperclassman looking to step up.
McBride runs it in. Osby low, muscle, foul called. Goes against Pruitt.
See McBride working well without the ball. Strawberry lost his man from range. Nothing but net for McBride. And off the penetration and kick, Jones in rhythm. Beckway from the bench, a cheerleader, a new role, an assistant coach tonight for Gary Williams.
He'd rather have him out on the floor.
Also, that's the understatement of the night.
4:10 left. Missed free throw. So, Bambali, Osby. Strawberry will take his last break of the night. This will be a brief one. He's too important defensively. Maryland is only 5 of 10 from the free throw line as a team here tonight in Champaign. Make it 6 of 11. A two-point lead now at the 4:10 mark. Let's see what the Illini come up with against this press.
Tough place to catch the ball right along the baseline. No space to operate. Meacham just trying to protect the ball. And the Illini able to get that timeout. Don't want to inbound the ball or receive the ball, Brent, that close to the baseline. You run out of space, it acts as an extra defender, and then you got the Maryland trap on top of that.
You know, there's a long-time sports columnist here. He works on a radio, too, during the basketball games. He's really kind of a legend in downstate Illinois. Lauren Tate has had a street named after him. I said, Lauren, I don't even have a dirt road in Montana, my friend. What is this? He said, Brent, it's one way and a dead end. And there he is. He has been around Illinois athletics for so long. He's just part of the scene. You look forward to coming and chatting a little bit with Lauren. He does a radio show pregame. watching over there. Brian Barnhart, the fine play-by-play man for the Illini. This is a great basketball venue down here at Assembly Hall. If you like to check in on the various arenas, like coming up next, Cameron, of course, is a classic. But one of the better ones is right down here in Champaign, Assembly Hall. This is some scene in here, 16,000 plus, adorned in orange.
Lauren is a resident expert on the Big Ten as well.
Isn't he?
Walking history book when it comes to this conference, the coaches, the players, the history of this league, the rich heritage and tradition. Good press break. A little two-on-one. They've got numbers.
No foul call? Yes. You got it. For a second when the crowd responded, and they were responding to the aggressiveness, I think, of the hit. Take a look at this. This is his fourth foul. No question. He came over and bodied him hard.
Whatever it is, you can get it on eBay.
When you get a cold, you can't always slow down, but you can get the relief you need to keep going. With NyQuil at night and DayQuil during the day. Feel better faster.
Why wouldn't I want the last shot when I know I've already made it?
Technology has made your morning easier. Why not your shave? The Philips Norelco Smart Touch XL is designed to shave more, with three shaving rings in each shaving head. And it stays on your neck, so even tricky hairs are cut. Simplicity is making every stroke count.
In Africa, it's all about diamonds.
Here in Smuggler.
How about Soldier of Fortune?
The White Stone can buy anything.
That makes us partners!
I am not your partner!
Is it possible that you don't care how many people die because of the deals you do?
Hold on!
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Will God ever forgive us for what we've done to each other?
Blood Diamond. Rated R. Special sneak preview Saturday. Everywhere December 8th.
Class of 94. Here I come.
When you want to make a good impression, Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up free and get you going in style.
Looking good, Moose.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Scott Reese with the SportsCenter in-game update. Florida State and Wisconsin on ESPN2 in a typical Badger effort. Great defense and just enough offense. Get it to the polar bear, Ryan Butch, for two of his 12. He's also got five boards. Wisconsin up 11 over the Noles. And, of course, coming up at 9:07 Eastern time, DJ White and the Hoosiers heading into Cameron. Duke has never lost in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, guys.
All right, here's a look at tonight's PlayStation game track. Maryland, now they've shot 71%, but they've turned it over nine times, and that's led to 12 Illinois points. Sean Pruitt coming up big here with 11 of his 14 points in the second half. So two shots here for Trent Meacham at the free throw line for the Illini. That's his first free throw of the night. He can tie the game with a second. Brian Randall watching from the Illini bench. He is out until probably mid-December with the groin injury, which required surgery. Missing the second, stays on the one right now. 59-58, 3:50 to go. Jones feeds Vasquez, who's been very active in the paint. Won't go down. Battle. Carter coming away with a rebound. The Illini searching for the lead. Pride being defended by Jones. Takes him into the paint. Kicks it now to the big man. Carwell not there.
The
This is the streak, 51 straight non-conference home wins. It was the loss to George Washington back in 98.
Good game management there in terms of time and getting your star players a little low. Gary Williams used the timeout as well as the first exchange of possessions here since that timeout to rest Osby and Strawberry. Now he's got them down the stretch.
Get in low. Pruitt on the turnaround. Won't fall. Maryland. Vasquez. Vasquez kicks inside and one. A push event. Osby, unnecessary. He had the field goal. And I would say the player of the match is Gravis Vasquez. Grew up in Caracas.
Such a tremendous talent. This is open court, scattered floor situation, just spoon feeding Osby. Just open wide. I'll get you the ball. Great emotion, great passion. Mr. Ginobili, that's not a bad call.
This is where it reminded me of that Latin South American flair. They hurdle their bodies around. But Ginobili is one of the more entertaining players that I've been around. 61-58, Maryland.
I'd love to play with someone like Vasquez, who's going to get you the ball where you can do something with it. So often guards hold on to the ball too long, or they give it to you just a split second late, and your opening closes down. But Vasquez gives you the ball at the right time, at the right place.
McBride off the dribble, not there. Maryland pulls the rebound down. They lead it 3, 2:25 to go. Big trip. Vasquez running the show right now. Waved off. Foul. And it's against the Illini.
Talk about confidence and swagger as a freshman coming into Assembly Hall. And just putting on a clinic here. Precision. Slicing and dicing.
17 fouls against the Illini. We're shooting 1-on-1 right now. And Pruitt picks up his fourth foul. Front end on the money. What a game Vasquez is turning in for Gary Williams here down the stretch. And remember, he was bloodied in the first half. Needed a cut man over there on the bench. Repaired him, sent him back onto the floor, and he's been the main cog here. 63-58 with 2:10 to go. 15 points, 3 assists for Vasquez, who's now running the show for the Terps. Meacham gets caught up and draws the foul.
Gary Williams having the feel and the confidence to spread the court and let Vasquez go to work. That's a veteran coach. Think of the run they've had at Maryland. It was 11 straight NCAA tournaments. The last two, they've been absent from the field to 65. But you're looking at a future Hall of Famer, not a question of if, just when he will go in.
You're talking Williams, not Vasquez, right?
Well, that's right. It's a little too quick to put Vasquez in the Hall of Fame. But this man right here, I really believe he's in that next wave with Roy Williams, Rick Pitino.
We've got inside of 2 minutes left here. It's a three-point game. And checking in for the Illini, Calvin Brock. Meacham will sit. Little offense, defense now. Here comes Vasquez. Frazier has his hands full on him. Frazier on Vasquez, picks the dribble up. Over to Jones. McBride is there. And a timeout. 20 seconds on the shot for Gary Williams and the Terps to come up with a play. All right, you mentioned the Hall of Fame. Let's go to your list right now.
Well, you've got the active coaches, and I believe Gary Williams is right there along with Roy Williams, Rick Pitino, and Tom Izzo. You know, all have national championships. And then you look to the retired coaches. I believe these four right here, Coach Tarkanian with the national title, a former Maryland Terp head coach, Lefty Dreisel. Look at the 700 club there, and Gene Cady, a 25-year run at Purdue. And we'd like to see these statesmen of the game, the ambassadors, their contributions, not just in terms of winning programs, but being great statesmen for the game of college basketball.
Lefty's son and assistant coach with Gary Williams. A three-point game here, 144 to go, 63-60. Maryland, it's the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Seconds on the clock. Strawberry just kicks it in, deflected. Stolen by Vasquez, driving good. 65-60. Vasquez, the freshman, puts up 17 here tonight.
Is he a joy to watch?
McBride forces the three. No. Rebound, Maryland. Osby, and for the Terps, they're closing in now. 110. Up five. Vasquez has stepped up huge here tonight in Champaign.
This kid's been on a college campus for a couple of months, Brent. Comes into Assembly Hall, directs traffic, the quarterback, the player of the game. On both ends of the floor.
Watch this steal.
Oh, the anticipation there.
And then saying, I'm coming in, big fella. Try to stop me. Now Strawberry moves to the free throw line. Starting to look like Maryland has found a leader here tonight. Gravis Vasquez. A 15-point second half, trying to snap the Illini's 51 consecutive streak against non-conference opponents here in Champaign. Inside of a minute. The Illini have to hurry now. They can take the two or the three. They got to go. Frazier off the dribble. No foul. Maryland. And the foul is against the Illini. It's against Frazier. There's the streak we just mentioned. Have to go all the way back to 98. This will be the first non-conference loss in Champaign if Maryland holds on in this century. Not that it's that old, but 44 ticks of the clock left. Maryland without Ibekwe, out with an injured ankle. See, I told you fellas wouldn't miss me here tonight. You bet they did. I mean, the Illini probed away down low.
Well, it's inevitable that at some point during the season, Ibekwe may be in foul trouble. He may get another injury. And this will be a reference point for Maryland to know they can collectively, in a collaborative effort, find ways to win and in a tough place, snapping a 51-game non-conference winning streak. And again, how often do we talk, Brent, about guards? Gary Williams has the luxury of four tremendous guards.
Big freezer. It's on a two-possession line. Make it a seven. 44 seconds. A little pressure in that backcourt. Seconds ticking away. They have just got to hurry. They've got no time now to yo-yo it away. They've got to go faster than this. They have got to start jacking it. Frazier off the dribble, throws corner. Here's McBride. No. Knocked away. Foul called Maryland. And let's check in quickly with Reese.
Brent, it looks like a huge win for the ACC there. Big Ten holding court at home. Wisconsin on top of Florida State, 55-37. And Georgia Tech with a little trouble at Penn State at home, 37-34. And we are just 3 minutes away from Indiana and Duke. Cameron Indoor is coming up next.
Cameron Indoor rocking already, Reese. And here, Pruitt steps to the free throw line. Sit back down now to a six. 26-3.
Four outstanding perimeter players, Brent, for the Terrapins. Eric Hayes, Gravis Vasquez, DJ Strawberry, Mike Jones. When they get Ibekwe back, they'll be a force in the ACC this year. A couple years ago, Bruce Weber, a little role reversal. When they had Darren Williams, Luther Head, D. Brown, Roger Powell. This Illini team doesn't have that type of personnel on the perimeter. They have capable players. They're just going to have to find a way to be competitive. generate wins in a different way.
The Illini without a field goal in the last 4 minutes. Gary Williams' defense shuts them down, playing without Ibekwe. Bambali Osby steps in underneath, but there is the man who led the way, the freshman. Gravis Vasquez grew up in Caracas, Venezuela. 6'5", 195 pounds. They'll get him back. He said to Aaron that he was 50% with that injured ankle. Road returns. 25.7 left. Back on the setting.
I'm not sure I can remember, Brett, two freshman guards in Hayes and Vasquez coming into such a tough environment this early in the season and playing with such great poise.
They've stolen it from Meacham, and he reaches in and fouls. So Jones is coming up here, and Maryland, it is clear, is going home with this W. So they will make it 2-0. ACC. I don't believe that was the final that Reese showed us with Wisconsin, although clearly the Badgers are headed for a win over Florida State. So that is a big game going on between Georgia Tech and Penn State, and I might say an improved Penn State team this year. And then Indiana and Duke, just as soon as we finish. That'll be the next one here. And over on ESPN2, you can peek on how the Wildcats are doing against Miami. So the Hurricanes play Evanston tonight. And Maryland and Coach Gary Williams coming away with a big win in Champaign. Couldn't finish off the dribble. Tap back in. Good. 10.9 left here in the game.
You know what's impressive, Brent, when you look at Maryland's effort tonight? They get out to the early lead. They were hot, caught fire early. Illinois makes their run, which is going to happen over the course of season. Teams make runs. There's an ebb and a flow. Yet they answered on the road and extended with freshmen playing a critical role in putting this Illini team away.
Let's go back and show you the Vasquez work here tonight. On the drive, turning the corner. Off curl, knocking down the jump shot. Then that steal. And that was a crushing blow late in the game. Illinois' chances.
Vasquez and Hayes stepping to the foul line with great poise, knocking down free throws.
Well, you take a look at the Illini schedule. It doesn't get any easier in their next game. They're headed out to Arizona in Phoenix to play the Wildcats. So Arizona and Illinois coming up out west. At least the Illini are not going down to Tucson. And then Illinois, Chicago, Belmont. Tough game against Missouri in St. Louis. Idaho State and Xavier in Cincinnati. So it's not a cakewalk here. And Indiana and Duke just beginning. So we'll be flashing to that one just as soon as we end it. Here is Gist. Battle. Illinois got it. Step back out. Beecham's across the line. Tap back. Good. It's a two. And it's a four-point game. 3.6. There it is. Strawberry. We'll just run it out. Jam it in for a six-point victory margin. With 5 minutes left, this game was tied at 55. And Maryland closed it out 17-11. And Illinois' non-conference winning streak ends at 51. Indiana versus Duke coming up next. For Steve Lavin, Aaron Andrews, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Brent Musburger. So long, everybody. Now let's go to Dan and Dick at Duke.
Hi, Brent. Thank you very much. 2-0 ACC just underway here. A minute and change in. No score. Indiana and Duke.
at Cameron Indoor Stadium with Dick Vitale and Doris Burke. I'm Dan Schulman. The ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's in a game here in Durham, Duke, that has the Duke faithful really fired up for this one.
Well, you know, Dan, congratulations to Maryland. They ended a 51-game home winning streak against non-conference teams with the Fighting Illini, and Duke has 44 in a row against non-conference.
Lance Thomas, one of three freshmen in the starting lineup tonight for the Blue Devils, gets Duke on the board with the first bucket of the game.
You and I were really impressed with him against the Air Force. He played exceptionally well against a good Air Force team.
To update you on the starting lineups, Greg Paulus is not in the starting lineup tonight for Duke. He will play, and he'll play extensively, but turnovers, just getting back into the rhythm of things after the foot injury has been an issue for Paulus. And for Indiana, Lance Stemler, a junior college transfer who's been outstanding for them, is out with a concussion. Took an inadvertent kick to the head in practice a couple of days ago, and he will not play tonight, and that's a big loss for Indiana.
He's a junior college All-American from out of Illinois. He was 5-for-9 from the trifecta.
Nelson right, and Big Ben Allen muscles it up and in.
Marcus Nelson, outstanding baseline player. Prolific scorer, came out of the Scholastic ranks, over 3,400 points in California to be Uno number one.
And healthier this year, he figures to have a vastly increased role. Here he is again on the run out.
That's a big dilemma for Indiana. We talked about it before the game. You and I talked to Kelvin Sampson about it. Turning the ball over will be a disaster for them.
When you get a cold, you can't always slow down. But you can feel better faster with NyQuil at night and DayQuil during the day. Together, they can give you the relief you need to keep going. So leave the coughing, aching, and fever behind with NyQuil at night and DayQuil during the day. Feel better faster.
Well, a terrific start for the Blue Devils here tonight. 5-1 on the season. Indiana comes in at 3-1. Duke's lost to Marquette. Indiana's lost to Butler. Indiana with their first true road game of the season. Josh McRoberts and company coming off an impressive win over Davidson on the heels of their loss to Marquette. As we mentioned, three freshmen, Henderson, Ashire, Thomas in the starting lineup for Duke. Kelvin Sampson, his first year as head coach of Indiana, and his starting lineup is still a work in progress. Bassett with the ball right now, a freshman, and Callaway, both of his best ball handlers in the lineup tonight. They've really got to improve their ball handling, their decision making, and as you said, cut down on the turnovers.
Got to cut down the turnover, so they got to get D.J. White inbound.
A.J. Ratliff gets involved as Indiana finally scores.
Well, Ratliff, a good wing player. They also have a good guy coming off the bench in Wilmot, who provides some offensive firepower.
A real spark for them. Greg Paulus getting ready to come back, come in for the first time. That's a kick ball. Had a chance to visit with Kelvin Sampson and shoot around it again before the game today. And some of the things he had written up on the board. Play with poise, have some fun, but his biggest concern is the turnovers and also Duke's offensive rebounding capabilities. You saw Paulus is into the game right now. Shire goes strong to the hoop. The rebound brought down by Allen.
Well, coach, you say have some fun, but it's pretty tough to have fun when you get blown out. And you're turning it over. There's another turnover, baby. These aren't apple turnovers either.
Already the third turnover committed by the Hoosiers. Dukes, they've had a problem with turnovers as well. That's one of the reasons why Paulus didn't start last game or tonight. Here's McRoberts, and he is a gifted ball handler for a man his size. Allen is forced to foul him.
Could utilize either hand. Go left, go right. He can handle it either way. Look at Coach K and the amazing record he's achieved here at Duke.
A win tonight, and he moves into the top 10 among all Division I coaches in the history of the sport.
And he's got a few more years.
Yes, he does.
He's got a few more players, too.
Thomas has it knocked away. Boy, the turnovers have plagued both teams. Three aside already. Ratliff open on the wing. A little bit strong on the three.
And that's what he really does well, shooting the three. Had a really down year last year. Played well his Diaper Dandy year.
Paulus averaging almost four turnovers per game, but he'll also pick up the assist as Nelson buries the tray.
Led the ACC in assists last year. They want him to reduce those turnovers because they feel when he turns it over on the perimeter, it's a layup the other way. We saw it against Marquette.
And when And he's in there. Shire is open for more shots. McRoberts can get down to the post a little bit more, and everything is in sync. Bassett has worked his way into the starting lineup for the Hoosiers.
Trying to get a little screen and roll for DJ White.
And White is fouled. It'll be Paulus with the foul as we step aside. 4:42 into the game. Duke with an early 7-point lead. Paulus the fine to Nelson. And the junior is hot early here at Cameron.
Dr. Pepper Championship Saturday kicks off at 1 Eastern on ABC.
At T. Rowe Price, successful investing is about balancing risk and reward intelligently. For each 1, 5, and 10-year period, over 70% of our mutual funds beat their Lipper average, finding the right opportunity. Low-cost mutual funds from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a complete prospectus or profile with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
The Philips Norelco Smart Touch XL adjusts to your face for a closer shave with 50% more shaving surface and 3 shaving rings in each shaving head. Philips Norelco, the world's best-selling electric shaver. Simplicity is making every stroke count.
Whatever it is, you can get it on eBay.
Two options: change the road or change the SUV. Introducing the Acura MDX with super handling all-wheel drive. Technology takes it to a whole new place. Acura. Advance.
Hockey's back, like you've never seen before. NHL Center Ice on DirecTV. Your favorite teams, your favorite players. Break out of the ordinary with up to 40 games a week of unbelievable action all season long. Just 4 payments of $42.25. Act now and score big. To order, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS today. NHL Center Ice on DirecTV.
Tonight's game is being broadcast on ESPN HD, presented by Olivia. 9-2 Duke early over Indiana. This is the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's. Let's go to Doris Burke now for some thoughts on Greg Palmer. Doris?
Well, Dan, the 4.5 weeks he spent nursing that foot injury clearly had an impact on Greg's game, but also a ripple effect on the entire team. Josh McRoberts forced to do some handling of the basketball, John Shire as well. Coach Krzyzewski, in an attempt to help him out, broke down tape for an entire day, then spent Friday night several hours with Greg trying to reassure him, get his confidence back. It's ironic, guys, because Kelvin Sampson told us at his shoot-around, that's the one position you cannot win a national championship without. For Duke, their season rests with how good this guy is.
Armin Bassett off the inbounds knocks down the three.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, Doris. The point guard slot today in college basketball is a key. If you don't get great point guard play, very difficult to get to the winner's locker room.
Ryan Subek, 7-1 freshman, number 55, lost the handle there for Duke. He has just come into the game, as has David McClure, real spark off the bench for the Blue Devils. Roderick Wilmot, who is their spark off the bench, has checked in for Indiana as the foul is committed by DeMarcus Nelson, his first.
Very sloppy right now. Both clubs really having a difficult time getting any rhythm whatsoever. You know, Duke lost a lot of players in 99. They were 37-2, and they lost the likes of McGetty. They lost all those superstars,
Avery,
Langdon. And they came back strong. The following year, just reloaded. Get back with a group of guys like Mr. Boozer, Dunleavy, Williams.
What terrific defense by McRoberts. Forced Allen into a turnover. No basket. Foul before the dunk. But McRoberts playing defense 25 feet away from the basket made Allen pick up his dribble.
Again, turnovers really creating a nightmare for Indiana. But you know, the following year, after 99, when they lost to Connecticut in the title game, 2000, they went 29-5, lost in the Sweet 16 to the Gators of Florida. They had Nate James, though, and Battier and Tyrell to give those diaper dandies a chance.
to be able to get accustomed to college basketball.
Galloway out, Ratliff back in for the Hoosiers. McRoberts can shoot it from out there. Not this time. A Hoosier got knocked down, and McClure comes up with a rebound. Hollis misses a three, and McClure taps it out, but into the hands of Bassett. 2-on-0 for the Hoosiers, and Indiana's back within a deuce.
Not a good play right there by Hollis, trying for the steal at midcourt. Doesn't get the steal. They come up with the conversion, go down and get an easy layup.
How about Armand Bassett, the freshman who, as we mentioned, has worked his way into the starting lineup, averaging 3.5 points. He's already got 5 tonight.
Well, he'll get more playing time in plays like that.
Nelson hangs a little bit strong, and the rebound ripped down by DJ White, who has not been a presence so far early tonight.
He's got to play with more energy. He's got to get really excited and really want the basketball. Number 3 in the middle when you talk DJ White.
Right now he's got 7-1 Zubek on him.
Should be too quick for Zubek, 1-on-1. Should be able to take him to the basket.
A carry called on White. Another Indiana turnover.
He's been foul trouble. It's been really the problem for DJ White. Take a look at it right here. Reducing those minutes, he becomes an assistant coach. I'll tell you one thing, Mr. Schulman. You don't want that guy sitting next to you for half the game.
A long layoff for Indiana, Dick. They were beaten by Butler, did not get to New York, did not get to the semifinals of the NIT season tip-off. They haven't played in 9 days. Is that a factor at all?
Well, you don't have 9 days to get a little bit more familiar with a new system, get accustomed to one another. That can be a positive rather than a negative.
Gerald Henderson has that shot rejected. Indiana's picked it up at the defensive end of the floor.
Play with a lot of passion. They're playing hard, playing with intensity.
That's kind of the credo of Kelvin Sampson. He wants them to start playing the way his Oklahoma teams did. Ratliff inside White. Little double clutch. Then he went up into traffic and had it blocked.
Zubik with the block.
Nice lead pass. McClure up and under.
McClure's been giving him some positive minutes off the bench. Had that knee injury last year. I think Zubik is one heck of a post player at Duke.
A timeout called by Indiana. Again, great perimeter defense by Duke, forcing the Hoosiers way away from the basket. Hey, tomorrow on ESPN, the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's continues. Michigan State will take on Boston College, and then the game will have for Chapel Hill. Wow. Number 1 Ohio State, but what a test they're going to have against the Tar Heels. Two young, talented teams. And the Buckeyes right now, number 1 in the BCS Bowl, number 1 in the Coaches Bowl, number 3 in the AP Basketball Bowl. This is basically unprecedented. If Ohio State could win this week and maybe in the AP poll move up to number 1, never before, while both seasons were going on concurrently, has the same school been ranked number 1 in both AP polls. You've had it where one sport has ended or the other's about to begin, but in season, this could be unprecedented for the Buckeyes.
Well, it was one time back in the early 70s, a school at the Golden Dome, the Fighting Irish, were number 1 for 1 week, coached by a guy by the name of Richard Digger Phelps. Never met him. And also in football, they finished that year number 1.
Yep.
Oh, he's working right now in the studio. I mean, with Jay and Stacy, what a trio.
Now, speaking of perfection, in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, Duke is the only undefeated team. They won in Bloomington last year in a game that you and I did a great. Marco Killingsworth was phenomenal for Indiana. J.J. Redick was just as good for Duke in one of the loudest environments any of us has ever been in. Duke won by 7.
Killingsworth had 34 in that game. He was dominating, but they shut down in that game Indiana's perimeter shooters, who were averaging about 13 threes a game.
Good position inside by White, but Zubek altered the shot.
Zubik's size is a factor. It really is. They're playing White tough on the inside. Look at Zubik trying to battle him on a post. There's that high extension at 7-1.
Meanwhile, Ben Allen, who's 6'11", he's had 6'6 David McClure on him, but because Allen's more comfortable on the perimeter, Indiana hasn't been able to take advantage.
Yeah, he likes to shoot the three.
Bassett short. Allen keeps it alive. Zubek has it for Duke. Paulus all alone. Lost it.
Turnovers, baby. That's been the reason that Mike Krzyzewski has not been content. He's still feeling his way to get in the rhythm of the game.
Here's Allen. This is what he likes to do. Misses that three. And it'll be Duke basketball.
Saw a stat that really blows my mind. Ready for this? Duke, 10 consecutive years, either won the ACC tournament or the regular season. That is consistency.
9-7 Duke will have an amazing story. You'll have to see it to believe it, what Duke freshman John Shire did in high school.
I cherish the memories of a question my grandson asked me the other day when he said, "Grandpa, were you a hero in the war?" Grandpa said, "No, but I served in a company of heroes."
Guy has plans for you, and his plans are pretty elaborate.
Turistas.
I don't want to go home.
Rated R starts Friday.
I'm just like you. I work hard every day. Back pain or not, because I get big relief from the Icy Hot Back Patch.
Bigger than many ordinary patches. First, it's icy to dull the pain, then hot to relax it away. The Icy Hot Back Patch.
Count on it.
One big life, four ways to dress it.
Now stop! There ain't no more!
It lives in the walls. It's here to do God's work.
This is not what God wants!
Now it's on DVD, starring Kane. See no evil. Own it today.
Lori and Jim Shire, the parents of Duke freshman John Shire. Dad told me last week they're living the dream. Imagine how they felt on this night in high school when John put on one of the greatest scoring sprees in high school basketball history. His team was down 13. Glenbrook North was trailing by 13 to Proviso West. Couple of free throws, a three-pointer, and he's fouled and makes the free throw. Steals the inbounds pass, he scores and makes the free throw. And it just keeps going and going. A three for Shire. Another three for Shire, one of two free throws, another three before finally fouling out. 21 points, Dick, in a minute and 15 seconds.
And Coach K was sitting there. He witnessed the entire scene. Think about this. This young man was Mr. Illinois. His high school coach, David Weber, brother of Bruce Weber. Yet because of the strength of Duke, he says yes to Duke and a mom and dad. Look, he's on a cell. They're telling him he's on a cell. Somebody called him up, said you're on TV.
You're on TV. You know what John Shire said a few days ago, the last few years in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. He's from Illinois. He's been rooting for the Big Ten. But he says for the next 4 years at least, I'm going to be an ACC fan when it comes to the challenge.
He's already wearing those Duke outfits.
Nelson elevates and scores. He'll head to the line as well. 9 of the 11 points for Duke scored by DeMarcus Nelson.
If he stays healthy, he's going to have a big year, Dan. His dilemma has been all kinds of injuries throughout his career. Nice little fake out of the triple threat position, the medium range jump shot.
Well, you talked about how people have to step up with Reddick gone and Williams gone, Dockery, Melchione. Nelson might be the most likely candidate because of his health and because of the role he now has as a junior and a tri-captain on this team.
If Duke is going to be a top 10 basketball team by the end of the year and legitimate in the top 10 in America, the three veterans have to really give them consistent play. Paulus, McRoberts, and Nelson. And then you blend in those diaper dandies who are very, very good.
That three-point play snapped a scoreless drought of better than 4 minutes. Indiana with just 7 points in better than 8.5 minutes. Mike White, a junior college player, into traffic. It'll stay with Indiana. White is getting minutes because Allen had to start because Stemler, the junior college All-American, is out after the concussion. So Indiana is not very deep at all in the front court tonight. Callaway back in for Ratliff.
Can't put the ball on the floor down in that 3 second area. Duke's going to rotate down, get all kinds of deflections.
Duke's been playing some outstanding defense early this season, allowing only 52.5 points per game. The only team to go over 60 against him was the only team to beat him, Marquette. Callaway has it swatted away.
Marquette did a great job defensively, forcing the turnover and converting off the turnover. Tom Queen's basketball team had a tough game last night as we watched the block shot right here against Valparaiso. Came back and pulled it out.
Nothing easy on the road, no matter who you are and who you're playing this season.
Well, Valpo played him tough, yep. But James was sensational. He was counted for all the last 18 points.
Shot clock a factor. Wilmont's layup rolls out. Allen tries to follow. Indiana gets it back.
Good hustle right there by the Hoosiers. Backing it out. Callaway's a key for Indiana. He's got speed and quickness. fitness, has to play under control.
Here's Wilmot, and a swat by McClure.
I like McClure. I thought he showed some tenacity against Marquette when he came off the bench. From out of Connecticut.
A guy who still may not be quite 100% healthy after the knee surgery, may never be 100% healthy, but what a spark he gives him off the bench.
Indiana doing a pretty good job defensively, a lot of deflections, creating problems, not allowing Duke to get into their motion.
Paulus on the bench right now. Nelson open in the corner.
teams are playing physically, both on the boards and with their defense. Their lack of execution at the offensive end is the thing that's troubling both coaches right now.
Gorney back in for the Hawkeyes. He checks in for Cyrus Tate as you watch Steve Alford trying to get that right combination on the floor. With Henderson on the bench, this is not a deep Iowa team by any stretch. He goes seven. If they go eight, they're pushing the envelope. Shot clock is now single digits. Crowd getting into it. Tyler Smith spins and throws up a tough shot. Can't keep it alive. Dowdell. Oh! Washington with a follow.
That was a pass, if you believe that.
I'll take your word for it.
Dowdell's going to claim that was a pass in the film session, I guarantee it. Crowd coming alive a little bit now, huh?
Oh, yeah. Student section. Iowa's going right into the student section. Haluska now with 13 points.
Nice answer. This is a good player. Academic All-American as well, 2 years in a row. So he can study and play.
And Gordon looking inside. Dowdell now says, I'll drive it in.
Patient offensively, working for the good shot.
Shot clock is now at 9 and 8, and there's the steal, but they get it back. Dowdell, great dish inside. Up and under and the roll.
What a pass. Man. Looked like Peyton Manning on his fourth look.
Look at that. The orange. Sea of orange into that end zone.
That's fun to look at.
And they're loud. They're excited about this basketball team. Tyler Smith has just been off tonight.
1 for 11 now.
Wow.
Dowdell is, if he were a quarterback, he would be threading the needle. Watch this pass. Right between three black jerseys. And a little. Jaquite gets it in.
Jaquite will leave and get a big ovation. The senior Coleman Collins now back in.
Coleman was 2 for 4 in the first half. Should have been 4 for 4. Missed two dunks.
There's Haluska, 16 points.
It's interesting to think about Iowa, Doug, and what how much better they're going to be when Henderson gets back, because he started 34 games last year. Very experienced point guard. They'll be a lot smoother at the offensive end.
All right, there's the steal. Bob, what do you think?
This is a pass. Watch this. It's a pass.
Denver faces off against Colorado College Friday at 9:30 on ESPNU.
At mealtime, everyone's in a hurry and everyone wants something different. So how can you make everyone happy? With the revolutionary Sunbeam Rocket Grill. It's a whole new way to grill that lets you make a delicious meal in 10 minutes or less, even if it's frozen solid. The amazing Sunbeam Rocket Grill will transform the way you cook. This steak went from frozen to fantastic in just 8.5 minutes. Make all these delicious foods 3 times faster with 3 times less fat and no cleanup. No other grill can do all that. The secret is in these one-of-a-kind vertical grill plates that cook the food from both sides quickly and evenly. Meanwhile, these innovative parchment pouches seal in the flavor, making everything you cook tender and delicious. Plus, the Sunbeam Rocket Grill removes 3 times more fat than other cooking methods.
When I'm cooking a hamburger, the amount of grease that is caught on the bottom of the bags is amazing.
Best of all, you just toss away the mess, and Sunbeam makes it easy to get more parchment pouches. Don't spend time scraping and scrubbing a greasy mess. Don't spend 40 minutes broiling. And don't cook your food in all that fat. Yuck. Make it fast, make it fantastic, and just toss away the mess with the incredible new Sunbeam Rocket Grill. The Sunbeam Rocket Grill is not available in stores, so you must act now. There's no risk with our 30-day money-back guarantee. When you order, you'll get 30 parchment pouches, this handy grilling guide with ideal cooking times, these specially designed stainless steel tongs, and this recipe book full of great ideas for fantastic meals, satisfying sandwiches, kids' favorites, side dishes, and more. Call in the next 15 minutes. We'll give you another 30 parchment pouches free. That's 2 months worth of parchment pouches absolutely free. Plus, Sunbeam makes it easy and convenient to order more parchment pouches whenever you need them. You get all this for one low price, but you must act now.
The Sunbeam Rocket Grill is not available in stores. You can only get it through this special TV offer. So call 1-800-509-0418 or visit GetRocketGrill.com. Checks and money orders also accepted. That's 1-800-509-0418 or GetRocketGrill.com. Don't wait. Order now.
Virginia Tech on top of Iowa, 36-29. The ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's. Doug Bell and Bob Wenzel. There's Ron Washington's number so far. Had that injured elbow. I wasn't sure if he was going to play tonight. He's played well. In fact, he has a little support. Denise is watching him tonight. Oh, mom, huh?
How about that? They are from New Orleans, Doug, and they had their house destroyed, and mom has moved to Blacksburg and teaches up here now.
Huh. Yeah, she was a basketball player at Xavier University in New Orleans. And, in fact, his dad played 15 years in the NFL and is currently an assistant coach with the Green Bay Packers. That's Lionel.
Wow.
So an athletic
good
family.
Good genes, huh?
Yeah. Absolutely. There's Gordon. You know, they really do a nice job on those inbounds plays. They
yes.
really do.
And you saw them working at it this afternoon in practice, right. Didn't you?
They get good looks. Back in is Tony Freeman.
Virginia Tech has not been able to get separation like they'd like in this game. Up 9 at halftime, only up 7 now. This guy's taking over the game.
Travel, shuffles those feet. He didn't like the call.
He didn't get taken out in the first half at all.
There's Craig Neal, the associate head coach for Iowa, and he's the inspiration over there. He gets on some people.
Inspiration? What do you mean by that? He's the volatile one,
yes.
Huh?
He wakes you up. He's the alarm clock. Let's put it that way.
Intense. He gets on them.
Here's Collins and Dowdell. Boy, they really slow it down, don't they? And they're very patient. Shot clock is now at 5. Dowdell's got to do something in a hurry. Oh, counted in the foul.
Well, you said he had to do something in a hurry, and he did. Nice use of the glass.
Boy, that's not going to make Coach Neal happy.
Dowdell has been doing this in the ACC for 4 years. Watch how he uses the glass to soften the shot. And one. He has only missed one free throw on the season.
Seth Gorney got over there late. Dowdell has scored double figures 21 straight games, trying to make it 22 tonight. Collins with the offensive rebound, and that gets blocked out of bounds by Cyrus Tate.
Well, this is the number one play. And well, you talked about what good out of bounds plays they have right here. Let's see if it works. Visayo in the corner. There it is.
Whoa, man. That's how they draw it up on the chalkboard.
I like the number one play.
And Dowdell comes up with another turnover now for Iowa. You see the students on their feet. They're pumped up.
Where is Virginia Tech going in the bowl game? I guess they could go anywhere.
Well, they're 10-2.
Out of bounds play. Both guys go with the screener. Collins wide open. An easy one. He's 1-for-3 on dunk so far in this game.
Dowdell with a nice dish to Gordon. Oh.
Oh, what a follow.
All right. The Hokies have the crowd on their feet. Football team going to the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl.
Ah, I like those.
Yeah, they're eating everything up tonight.
Every ATM fee from any machine at any bank anywhere in the country automatically refunded. You just have to celebrate. Go to eTrade.com and be blown away.
Great hitters are made, not born.
Derek Jeter here for Zip and Hit Pro, the great new hitting trainer that's guaranteed to improve your swing and make you a better hitter.
Zip and Hit Pro allows you to take batting practice almost anywhere. The batter attaches Zip and Hit Pro's anchor end to a pole, tree, or fence and sets it to the desired height. The pitcher pulls the durable nylon cord tight, and then it's just zip and hit.
Great hitters have to be able to hit all kinds of pitches. Zip and Hit Pro delivers fastballs, changeups, curves, and sliders at speeds up to 65 miles an hour. Plus, it teaches the top half hitting technique that gets you hits. You get a perfect pitch every time with Zip and Hit Pro, so you can quickly perfect your swing in every part of the strike zone.
Zip and Hit Pro is cool and really improved my batting average.
It's great for softball, too. It got rid of my chop and uppercut swings.
Zip and Hit Pro is fun and a great way to spend time together.
Zip and Hit Pro is only $29.95 and makes a great practice station. Order now, and as a TV bonus, you'll receive a special offer from Sports Illustrated Kids, the number one magazine for aspiring athletes. Plus, with your order, you'll also receive a free regulation-size home plate, plus the best-selling baseball training DVD, How to Hit and Run. Call now and get Zip and Hit Pro for only $29.95. Zip and Hit Pro is 100% guaranteed to make you a better hitter or your money back. You get Zip and Hit Pro, three issues of SI Kids, plus the free bonuses, a $70 total value for only $29.95 when you call and order now.
Zip and Hit Pro, a great way to become a great hitter.
From the makers of Hitaway.
The Hokies on a roll at home tonight, 42-29. Lost a couple of games in Orlando, and they've come back tonight, and the senior has been big.
The shoulders of Xavier Dowdell are pretty broad with this team. The pull-up jumper, the lost arm. What else can he do? Almost everything. Spots up from the three. He's got 10 points in this game. He's 4 for 9. He's got 4 assists. Watch this pass. Blind look inside to Sheck, and he gets it down. Dowdell is a leader. He's a great all-around guard, and he is a consistent scorer, and he's good on defense, too. Outstanding player.
Oh, the follow wouldn't go for the Hawkeyes. A block inside again. J.R. Engel's in there for Iowa. Brett Wessel's first shot of the night. And the big man inside, Seth Gorney, with a follow.
That is the first time that Iowa has asserted itself on the offensive boards for second shots.
Whoa! Coleman Collins
not getting back. That is the fifth dunk of this half for Virginia Tech.
14 minutes to play. Steve Offer going to his bench. Haluska looking for the big man Gorney and throws it out of bounds. Coverage of the NCAA Women's College Cup begins on ESPNU Friday with both semifinals, 3:30 Eastern. It's UCLA, North Carolina. That's a 3-1 matchup. And then at 6:30 Eastern, FSU, Notre Dame, a 5-1 matchup. The next stop, the championship, all on ESPNU, presented by Enterprise.
Great run here by Virginia Tech, really asserting themselves. Iowa's offensive woes very apparent.
Fouled inside, Masayo. Boy, Virginia Tech, Bob, just appears quicker.
Well, they are quicker right now, especially with the substitutes in the game right now. Iowa really obviously struggling to find some offense. Tyler Smith is a guy, number 34, who could do some things. Seth Greenberg very happy right now. They really spurted right here. They're getting it done with defense. This year they played very, very aggressively. Sayo, excellent shooter.
Yeah, 90% from the free throw line.
9 out of 10, now he's 10 out of 11 for the season so far. Sometimes statistics early in the year can be a little bit deceiving. Virginia Tech had 2 blowouts early where they won by 50 points, so that inflates some guys' stats a little bit. But there's no question that A.D. Vasayo is a very good shooter.
2 for 2. You saw Freeman check back in for Iowa, and Luby also back in for the Hawkeyes.
With 13 minutes to go, Seth Greenberg is trying to step up the pressure. He feels like he's got this big lead now. They want to play pressure without fouling. That's the trick of it.
Freeman being hassled out there, doing a lot of dribbling. Tyler Smith, Haluska. Boy, that's pretty.
He does not need a lot of room, does he? You have to credit some other players with that basket, too.
Another chance for a 3-point play. Vasayo on the drive.
Well, Steve Alford has to be beside himself right now because his team is not getting back defensively at all. In the first half, they made Virginia Tech struggle for everything they've gotten. This half, the Hokies are getting out in the break. They're not, Iowa not getting back quickly, and they're getting a lot of easy baskets.
Masayo hit those last two free throws. Oh, missed one. A rare miss for the second-year man from Puerto Rico.
Nice matchup here, Dowdell and Beluska, huh?
Beluska plays a lot of minutes for the Hawkeyes, and understandably so. He's the stabilizing force for this basketball team. And a foul inside. Freeman will go to the line and shoot two. Masayo gets his second foul.
Well, this is a good play by Freeman. When in doubt, take the ball with the basket. He goes into the trees right here, and he does pick up a foul. Iowa struggling just running their offense. They've got to find other ways to score. Little guy might be the answer to create.
Other scores now from the ACC Big Ten Challenge. BC on top of Michigan State. Purdue leads Virginia. And then later tonight, it's Ohio State and the Tar Heels. A 1-6 matchup. That'll be Ohio State's had an easy slate up to this point.
And North Carolina favored in that game. Mm-hmm.
Freeman misses that and will get one more chance. Lane violation. Getting the lane too quick was Masayo. And he is not sure. Not sure about that. If you say so. Yeah. Freeman takes advantage. Justin Johnson back in now. A smaller lineup, but a quick lineup for Iowa.
Well, that's what Alford's going to try to do. Create pressure, try to bring it up more, create some turnovers, see if they can get some breakouts. Very small team right now.
Munson being guarded by Freeman. Munson's the young man from D.C. who Bob talked about in the first half. Boy, great passing inside. And a foul against Luby.
Well, Luby came into this game. In five games, he's had 10 blocks. And that's pretty good for a young player right here. Good pass. This was repetitive jumping. Notice how Luby jumped, came down, and jumped right up again without gathering himself. He jumps right here, tries to get the block pass. Good athleticism. You can see how he's going to be a bit of a player.
Collins with a miss. Young man from Stone Mountain, Georgia. You know, he had a bad ankle right as they started practice, and it kept him out of those preseason condition drills, Bob, and it's just been a slow comeback for him.
Yeah, I think it's mental, too. I think the passing of his father is weighing on him, and you know, you can't look at anything, and I mean, he's still the same physical guy. I don't think he just has the fire right now.
Freeman. Looking inside, Luby. Throws up a tough shot.
There's his lack of strength. Uh-huh. He was at 2 feet, goes to 6 feet.
An intentional foul called on Freeman. He grabbed Ron Washington. You don't get that call too often.
And Freeman is complaining, but really, clearly it was intentional. It wasn't intentionally to hurt, but he grabs both arms with both of his arms. Now that's clearly an intentional foul. Not meant to hurt anyone. The rule, of course, is he will get the two free throws, and Virginia Tech will maintain possession of the basketball.
You know, it's interesting when you look at this, at least the top five, six, seven guys for Virginia Tech. This young man from New Orleans, you have a young man from Puerto Rico, Georgia, two from Florida, D.C., Molly.
Molly.
Not a lot of local kids, you know? I mean, Seth goes out and pulls them in.
International recruiting, huh? For those of you into geography, Molly is in Africa. Right there. Clearly intentional. So well, harm done.
Nope. The Hokies get the ball out from underneath their hoop, and here comes that inbounds play again. And again,
this was not number one. Number one was a dunk, remember?
I'd go back to one. Didn't get a shot this time. Here's Munson.
Hawkeyes trying to increase pressure. Very difficult, however, against Munson, Dowdell, and Gorman.
And Munson goes off to Collins. Shot clock is winding down. It's now at 10, and there's the steal. Tyler Smith goes off to Haluska. And a push on Tyler Smith. Boy, what a tough night he's been for that young man. Seth Greenberg, a man who wears, his emotions on his sleeve. Oh!
Shift shock. The next Nissan Maxima with CVT, part of the next generation of Nissan thinking.
Tuesday on ESPN, get fired up for the 2006 Jimmy V Classic. Live at Madison Square Garden, some of the most explosive teams in college basketball square off for a great cause.
Hustle, hustle!
Oklahoma State takes on Syracuse, followed by Louisville versus Arizona.
He got it!
Don't miss one of the year's great events in college hoops. The 2006 Jimmy V Classic, presented by Siemens. Tuesday at 7 and 9 on ESPN. For tickets, call Ticketmaster or visit thegarden.com.
Sunday. In this maximum security prison, inmates make rules.
We have control of everything that happens in the prison except the gates.
And with no bars or walls between them, many have separated themselves by the color of their skin as gangs formed by race are divided in war. Lockdown Gang War premieres Sunday at 9 on Channel 276, the National Geographic Channel.
Thursday night, all eyes are on Cincinnati. It's all business anytime the Ravens come to town. But Carson and the Bengals know how much this one means. In Baltimore, they're loving the new offense and talking playoffs. But in Cincinnati, Bengals fans still believe. Thursday Night Football heads to the jungle for a showdown of AFC North rivals. Thursday Night Football, live from Cincinnati when the Ravens battle the Bengals at 8 on NFL Network.
It's the third year in a row. All home games have been sold out for the Hokies. Another packed house tonight, and they like what they see. It's the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by Papa John's. The Hawkeyes of Iowa against the Hokies of Virginia Tech. Doug Bell alongside the coach, Bob Wenzel.